Good morning and welcome to day two here at the Nova Scotia Men's and Women's Curling Championship. Our action this morning comes from the men's side, from the Deloitte Tankard. My name's Jim Nix and I'm here with Sharon Clark, and we're going to be bringing you the game between Robert Mayhew and Chad Stevens. Both opposite records for these guys. Yesterday, Chad won his first game fairly large against Kendall Thompson, and Robert Mayhew struggled a little bit early in his game with Paul Dexter, made it a game, but managed to end up come up on the short side of that. Morning, Sharon.
Good morning.
Really pleased to bring you this game. It's one of about 27 or 28 games, I believe it is, this week, and really an exciting time here at the Mayflower Curling Club. Four draws today, this morning at 8, 12, 4, and 8. Two men's, two women's, alternate draws. Should be a great day of curling here at Mayflower. If you're around, drop in and take in the action. So, Sharon, is this your first day? You weren't around yesterday.
I wasn't around yesterday, nope. Unfortunately. Nope.
Well, we had a good start. Ice has been great, and the curlers have been great, and curling's been pretty good for the first day. So I think it'll just get better as we go on this week.
Yes, I'm going to be timing the rocks to see how fast the ice is, so it'll be interesting. Interesting morning.
Yeah, well, it was very nice yesterday, so we'll see how that looks. We actually didn't get any time yesterday, so that's good. Chad's lead, Kelly Middlestadt. Threw the first rock up as a guard. Mayhew threw the corner guard, and now Chad's asking Kelly to play the draw around. It would be normally an in turn. Kelly's left-handed, so that would be Kelly's out turn. Taking a little bit of time making its move.
Perfect rock. Just pretty well buried there, Jim.
Yeah, great shot. These guys are so good, eh? They really don't take very long to be able to make good shots.
No. Now that could be chipped out. Let's see how he does. The ice was 24 there, which is very fast, and I think the teams will like it.
Yeah, ice maker for this event, as we said yesterday, John Wall from the Ottawa area. John was the ice maker last year as well and does an amazing job, keeps everything running quite good, quite nicely.
Unfortunate, he was a little light on that.
Yeah, not a real good shot. He threw the corner guard on his first one, needed to add probably 10 feet and actually might have even taken a couple feet off. So, advantage Stevens early in the end, but it's really early in the end. We're only at the second stones.
So he wants to go top eight?
Yeah, just top eight, maybe half bury. It would be good. Fully bury would be really good, but he'd take a half bury. Wouldn't be bad here. Second for Chad's Ian Gerlink. Ian's played pretty much all the positions over the last few years. I've seen him playing back end. I've seen him playing front end. I think he's looking to be on a team that wins and quite happy to play whatever position it takes to make that happen.
Yes. Beautiful shot.
Yeah, great shot. So the Mayhew team in some trouble here early. You're going to have to kind of try to open things up a little bit. You hate to be chasing after just a couple of rocks and an end, but not much choice here. You need to get rid of something.
He has no chance of using that corner guard he put up yet, so he'll hope to be able to use that at some point in the end.
Yeah, quite often that you see they throw it up there and it doesn't get used, but at some point somebody might make a hit and roll or something like that. Mm-hmm. Neil Gallant. A little unlucky. If he got a bye, he might have been able to get something out of the house, but he does get rid of a couple of guards, and situation much better than it was before he threw.
Another guard for Stevens.
Chad, one of the two teams that didn't have to play in the pre-event qualifier to get into this event. He ranked second on C2S points at the November deadline, and as a result had a bye to the provincial championships. Had a very good year. We'll give you a little update on how that went as we go on. Guys are working pretty hard on this. They need to go really hard just to get it over.
Keep it curling. Ooh. Did it make it?
They think it did. Robert will go out and have a look at it, make sure he feels good about it, and if he's not sure, he'll have an official have a look.
Now, he could just come down with bumper weight and pop over behind that corner guard now.
Exactly. Just tough shots to have to throw here in the first end when you haven't really got your feet under you a whole lot yet, and you're trying to throw, you know, sort of finesse type shots. You'd like to have another end or so to,
yes,
before you had to do that.
I wondered if they'd hit for the first and second ends and then bear down in the third end, but guess not. They're going right at it.
Yeah, we see that very, very little in the men's game. We noticed that yesterday, the first draw on the ladies that I did in the morning was exactly like that. Every sheet across the board, except for one sheet. Sorry, I shouldn't say that. Marianne Arsenault and McConnery's game was pretty much flat out right from the start, but the other games played very defensively for a couple of ends, mm-hmm. Whereas the men's draw, a couple hours later, exact opposite. They started off with two center guards, and the other team had two corner guards, so very, very different approach to the game.
Right, much more interesting for the audience.
Oh, absolutely. Stephen's still sitting two in pretty good shape here, and very going very hard here because he could go down and hit the yellow one, take away that shot, but he knows he's in a pretty good position here. If Cameron McKenzie can make a decent draw here and get into the top of the 8 foot, he's going to have the Mayhew rink in a lot of trouble. Someone's going to have to do some moving.
Very offensive.
Yeah.
Like to see it. The rock isn't curling like a little heavier than he expected, I think. It's not good.
Yeah, just a tad heavy.
Mm-hmm. Not bad. Good shot.
Yeah, I think anytime you're sitting three in the first end and two of them are pretty much behind the guard, and that's a good sign.
Looking good. I think he's going to try the drop double here. Could be a thin double.
Yeah, he'll leave the one high one, the one at the one that's closest to us as we look at the camera.
Right.
But he may well get rid of two and sit number two, number three. So this is Chris McCray, I believe, in the hack.
This will be a heavy one.
Yeah, he'll throw this pretty firm, I think. This one looked a little wide out of his hand to me. Didn't throw it as hard as we thought he might throw it, but he might be caught in between here.
Yes. Well, opened him up a little bit.
Yeah, it's a good shot. I think it's one of those shots that you have to commit, and I don't know that they were. I assume they were trying to hit it thinner and make that double,
mm-hmm.
And if they were, they just didn't really commit on the sweeping. They kind of waited and then ended up right in the middle of both. And
yes. Now Chad's going after that rock.
Yeah. Cameron McKenzie, the third for Chad Stevens, and one of the committee members for the event here at Mayflower. Going hard. We still see most of the teams using one sweeper on takeouts, especially using the theory of a little bit of directional sweeping. And
yes, that's very interesting. I'm glad to see them doing that. Makes it fun. Gives the other sweeper a little break at the time, too.
Well, you know what? And the other thing it does, because of broomhead, the fabric on the broomheads now is so prone to wearing out that it actually saves the head a little bit. They only have one head for every game, and they can really, these guys sweep so hard, they can pretty much destroy that head, and sometimes 7-8 ends or less. And
true.
So it works out well that they're able to get a break here and there. And
so, Jim, I see that they're all using the same type of broom.
Yeah, I think Chad's team are using the hardline brooms.
So they are, yes.
There's a great shot.
Oh, beauty.
So a couple good shots here by the Mayhew team has at least taken some of the heat off of this end. They're at least now, there's a little light at the end of the tunnel. For a little while there, it was looking like they might have to draw the button just to give up a point.
Yes, this can be pushed out and stay.
I don't think he's going to try to do that. I actually think he's going to try to just throw what control weight or close to normal weight and just make sure it goes away. He'll probably lose his back one, but that's okay. Just judging by what I heard over the mics. We do have mics in the in the arena. Not on the players. Someday we'll hope to do that, but they're not on the players right now. But we do manage to pick up at least some conversation, and it certainly enhances the atmosphere of the broadcast, so we're happy to do that. Mm-hmm. Chuck and Sean, the guys in the booth, making all those calls and doing all the hard work. That's a nice shot.
That was a beautiful shot.
I guess he did exactly what you were talking about with bigger weight than I thought he could do.
It's a little straight there, so he was able to use that weight and make the shot effectively.
If there's such a thing as an easy triple, though, this would be an easy triple. I'm pretty sure that that will all go. And see, Neil Gallant holds the broom for Robert on his shots. He'll throw second, but holds the broom. Mm-hmm. This is back. This isn't correct. It's all the right people, but it's not the right order. So Robert Mayhew with a chance to get his team out of trouble here in the first end and needs a big shot. Robert struggled in the first couple ends of his game yesterday. We didn't do that game, but we did manage to see it. And
definitely not the commentator's curse there.
This is going to be pretty good, I think. I don't know if he's going to get them all. Well, that's still a good shot.
Okay, hold one.
Yeah. Had to curl a little bit more to be able to get rid of all of them.
Chad will try to hit and roll on this. Behind the guard or protecting that other shot?
Yeah, I think an ideal roll would probably be halfway between where the guard is and where the one on the back of the forefoot is, and sort of set up that little Christmas tree look. Mm-hmm. Make it a little tough. That would actually make it quite tough for Robert. Chad's probably thinking let's make it go away and make sure we stay first, just to force the 1 point.
Right.
But sometimes the difference between winning and losing at this level is that exact sort of thing, that little two-foot roll here or there that some teams try really hard to get and make, and other teams just don't. Going really hard. This one's going to be hard-pressed to hang around.
It is. Oh, it'll hang.
Yeah, the sweepers are so strong.
Yes, they can carry her off and keep it straight.
So I think...
So he's going to draw?
Yeah, he's looking, thinking hard. That was a good shot by Chad. Actually ended up rolling to a pretty nice spot. Makes it a little tougher. So Robert's going to play the hit. Nose hit gets him his point. Mm-hmm. Not really quite ready to risk the draw at this point.
He just threw it, so he knows the ice.
Yeah, exactly. Good point.
Nice control weight.
Yeah, not throwing real hard at this one. It's going to have to move a little bit. Usually, a lot of teams would have one sweeper on it right now, trying to make the rock curl.
Yes.
Has to come a little more yet.
Yes.
And I think he's okay.
I think he's okay. Going to have a look at it.
Yeah. So nice shot by Robert Mayhew to get his one here in the first end. He didn't really have nothing really built for him in that end, so he has to take his point and move on to the next end. Mayhew leads 1-0 after one end here at the Deloitte Tankard. You're watching Bell Alliant TV 1. And we're really thrilled to be back this year. We were here last year and did this event along with doing the Canadian Seniors and the Canadian Masters. Really busy schedule on TV 1 last year. Hopefully we'll have more events such as that in the future and we can bring in lots of curling. The other games this morning are Mike Fleming and Stuart Thompson on sheet one. Well, sheet two here in Mayflower, we'll go with those numbers. And Fleming actually scored two in the first end. Mike coming off a really rough game yesterday against defending champs Jamie Murphy, but he's got his two in the first end here, so that's a nice start for him. Paul Dexter took two in the first end against Kendall Thompson, leads 2-0, and Brett McDougall got one in the first end against Jamie Murphy with a 1-0 lead in that game. It's like Brent stole the one in his end. The other guys got their deuces with the hammer.
Marcus!
So corner guard going up, Sharon?
Yes, I'd say so, yeah. Mayhew put one in the house, and Chad is going for his two. Hoping to use that corner guard.
So I mentioned earlier that Chad had had a pretty good season. Chad played in five events this year. He went to Quebec at least once. Once, probably only just once, but had a win at the Bud Light Spiel in October and had a runner-up at position at the Lakeshore Spiel in really early in the year at the end of September. Runner-up again at the Charlevoix Casino event in Clermont, Quebec, which was a big one. Picked up $5,000 for the runner-up spot at that one. And tied for fifth at the Dave Jones Spiel here at the Mayflower. So pretty good year for Chad, and it's certainly a new team, at least most partly a new team. Cameron McKenzie moved up to third. Paul Fleming, who curled with Chad last year, is actually playing in with James Grattan in New Brunswick this year in their provincial playdowns, using the free agent rule to be able to do that. So good year for Chad.
Jim, when do the New Brunswick playdowns begin? Are they the same as Nova Scotia, or are they later in the week? Or
no, they have the month? They actually do it in, they do it differently. So they, I talked to Paul a week or so ago, and he was on his way to New Brunswick to play in the first qualifier. So they have two qualifiers where they declare four teams out of each one, two open events, mm-hmm. and then they'll play the provincial championship. So I'm thinking, I know that Paul's here this week, so he's not playing this weekend. Well, actually could be. This is only Tuesday or Wednesday or whatever, so I think that they probably are playing this weekend or next and in their second qualifier, and then the provincials will follow the very next week.
Okay.
Not 100% sure on the dates, but it has to be pretty close to that.
Mm-hmm.
The winning teams that will end up going to St. John's, Newfoundland for the Brier, and the Brier officially starts, I believe, on the 3rd of March, or the 4th of March, whatever that Saturday is.
Right. So rather than going around his corner guard, Chad elected to come and freeze to that rock on the 4 foot, the 4 foot.
Yeah, an aggressive call.
Yes.
And they made it well, so it's a good shot.
Mm-hmm.
Neil Glant will be asked to just come down and maybe move that a little bit, just loosen that up a little bit, unlock it, as they say.
Mm-hmm.
But even that's pretty good.
Looks like a skins game out here.
It does, yeah. Yeah, it's fun to watch. Chad opening it up now. He just knows that he's got to be able to get at that. His rock in the house is in a great position for him. He just needs to make contact with it at all to be able to get his blue one to count, but
mm-hmm.
you got to be able to get to it. So he has to open it up a little bit. Ian Jerlink makes the peel. These teams all have the ability, we mentioned yesterday, to throw the high hard one, and it's certainly a nice weapon to have.
So another guard going up to guard that rock on the 4 foot.
Yeah, I think that'll be the plan for the rest of the end if they can make perfect guards.
Mm-hmm.
Just a matter of making good guards. Robert giving the hand signal to get off of that one. I don't know what he saw. I thought Neil threw it pretty good, to be honest. I think he might have been thinking he was heavy, but he's not.
Nope.
Sweeper's got to get it over another couple of inches at least.
Mm.
Good shot.
Good one.
I think you'll see Chad take that off again, he's going to play the one in the house.
That guard's a little long, so I guess he feels he can work around it.
Yeah.
If he should hit the front one, that's fine, right?
Right. No, you're correct. I'm taking a lot of ice. The men don't take quite as much ice as the women, and actually some of the teams don't take as much ice as some of the teams, just the way they throw it.
Mm-hmm. Tight, maybe
a little bit, not bad. Going hard
on
though.
The front one.
So look it off it now. Make sure that they hit it hard enough to move it. The worst thing there is to just touch it, just feather it, and leave the guard there, and that
right.
would be a bit of a disaster.
Yes. Another guard going up.
It's it's really hard to throw five or six perfect guards in a row, so we'll see if this team can manage to pull that off.
Well, the ice is good. It's controllable and readable. Sometimes we have very swingy ice. It's hard, a rock can overcurl 2 feet very easily, but this ice looks really good.
Yeah, it's all about throwing the weight that you can work out a little bit with the brooms, and then for the sweepers to know what and how they have to do that. And
yes.
There's a super real skill to that, and a lot of people don't realize. A lot of people just keep sweeping no matter what.
You have to be looking up all the time.
And yeah. And it's important, too. You know, generally, you know, when you're learning to curl, everybody says, well, you know, sweepers worry about the weight, and the skip worries about the line, or whoever's in the house worry about the line. Mm-hmm. And that's true to a point, but when you're playing on ice like this that curls, the sweepers have to be very, very aware of exactly where it has to end up, because if the rock dies before it ever gets to where it has to go, it's not much use to anybody, and quite often the skip will be hauling wool because of the line, and the sweepers will know, well, we have to keep going. We have to keep it moving.
And that's when you need communication between your sweepers and your skip.
Yeah, exactly. This could be interesting. Nope.
You wanted the two there, but that was a tighter guard, so it had to go. But I think he did want the two.
Yeah, quite possibly.
But that's good.
He hasn't got much to work with. If you throw a couple of guards here, it's going to be really Chad looking at maybe drawing the 4 foot to score as one, the way this end is going so far. A few rocks to come yet, though. See, a little bit, surprisingly little ice for this shot. I would have thought you'd need more. Yesterday it curled a little bit more in the men's draw.
Yes.
Not sure about last night. I actually watched a couple of games here on Bell Alliant last night. My sister was playing, and I watched that game at Marianne, flipped back and forth a few times, and I never really paid enough attention, I guess, to know how much it was curling last night, but I know it curled a lot in the afternoon.
Was that sheet four that was curling so much?
Yeah, we've been doing the same games,
sheet three and four.
Yeah.
That's a good guard. Perfectly placed.
Yeah, it is really good. Chad would really like to make this run back. He'd really like to dislodge his blue one off of that yellow one.
Mm-hmm.
More importantly, I think now, is to get rid of the yellow one, because early on you'd look to just opening that up.
Seemed a little tight on that, but lots of weight. He has to hit
one
side.
This is going
to
be real close.
Oh, good one. Very good.
Yeah, the nice thing, too, by he almost made a guard. He didn't, not quite, but he almost had the perfect guard on it. So that changes up the end, and very nice shot by Cameron McKenzie there.
Mm-hmm. So Mayhew was wondering whether to come into the blue or to guard that yellow. What would you do, Jim?
I can't see the yellow. Oh, there it is. Okay. from where I'm sitting, I had Robert standing in the way. I never thought to look at the monitor. Yeah, it's a good question. I think you've got to try to move the blue one out if you can get to it.
Okay, the yellow is just almost on the button, but it's exposed.
Yeah, it's a little bit risky to throw the guard.
Yes.
But mind you, you've got quite a bit of room to work with, so you put it right on that first tee on Deloitte would be a pretty good spot to be. I'm not sure what he'll do here.
You know, I think he's calling the...
Sort of the hack weight hit?
Yes, hack weight,
yeah.
Bump it out and roll over for guard.
Yeah, I think you're thinking a little bit of defense first here, and I think that's a good idea.
Second end.
Yeah.
Don't want to give up a two.
Well, no, and if you do, you don't want to give up an easy two. You want
the
team to at least have to work to make that.
Right. All about the weight here. And the broom. Tight.
I thought he was a little tight. They're sure not worried about it yet.
No, little. Ooh.
No. That's pretty straight right there. That's only board weight.
Oh, it's just going to get by. Beautiful shot.
That's perfect.
To get it out. Lovely, lovely shot.
Just perfect weight control by Robert Mayhew.
Beautiful.
That's hard to throw at that with that weight. You know, if you're going to play that shot, you have to get rid of it.
I just skinnied the guard.
Yeah, it did. It was fairly close to the guard. That's, you know, where knowing the ice and knowing your sweepers and everything else, I guess, comes into play. And as you mentioned earlier, communication is really key there, because if that rock's a little bit lighter and nobody says anything, then it does hit the guard.
Yes.
But I think they knew about halfway down that they were going to make it. It was just a matter of how good they wanted to try to make it. By letting it curl a little bit more made Chad's shot a little bit more difficult.
Yes.
It's fairly open, but, you know, had it rolled another 2 inches less, it would have been really quite a difficult double. Still not an easy double.
No, it's not, because he has to just get around that guard and almost nose hit.
Yeah, Chad, one of those skips that can throw the high hard one. I think this one's not going to curl enough. I think he's going to just get the top one.
Yes. Trying to make it curl. If that hangs around, it'll be a good thing, but it's not.
So an opportunity here for the Mayhew team to maybe steal one in the second end would be a big steal, really, at this point. A lot of ice. He's only got about, what would that be, 3 feet of ice for the guard.
Mm-hmm. And is he going to want it to bite the 12-foot, or will he leave it out front?
I think he's going to leave it out front. If the line is good, I think he'll leave it out front. I think it's, if you bite the 12-foot, Chad's going to definitely try to make the double, mm-hmm. and I think I'd rather him try to figure out how to outdraw that rock myself.
Yes.
Or make a 15-foot run back instead of a 6-foot run back.
Right.
It's on its way anyway. We'll find out in a minute.
See. Weight looks good. I don't want it to curl too much.
And it looks like it's going to overcurl.
Yes.
So maybe they needed more ice after all.
I think they did.
Sometimes as you get out a little bit further, you get more curl too. So, you know, maybe that was a case there where they just took that little extra ice to get it, thinking that's what they would need. And in fact, they actually found a little bit more curl out there.
Mm-hmm.
Too bad. Missed opportunity for sure. I think it's pretty much a wide open, or almost a wide open hit for Chad and to blank the end. And I think, you know, just 35 seconds ago, he would have thought he was going to be in having to make something a lot tougher.
True.
Chad Stevens will throw this one pretty high and pretty hard, attempting to blank the end. And plus, he wants to take the curl out of this shot. Just cleaning.
Doesn't want to stay.
Oh, he's got to curl a little tiny bit, I think.
That's okay, I think. Looks good. So it's a blank end.
Good shot by Chad Stevens, but definitely a missed opportunity by the Mayhew team there. That's one that I think at the end of the game they might be looking back thinking, well, you know what, we had a real good chance to be up 2-0 after two and instead of just one. But it remains 1-0 here after two ends. The Deloitte Tankard, draw number 2 for the men. Men will play again at 4 o'clock today. Women will play at 12 and 8 today. And we will bring you two games from each one of those draws. Got Joel and John on the other sheet doing the Dexter-Kendall-Thompson game. Another great game, lots of rocks in play over there too, so if you're doing a little bit of surfing back and forth, I can't blame you for that. Certainly take the opportunity to catch up on both games. Or have two computers, that'd be even better. Set up and
watch them both.
Could have used that at the hotel last night. I was flipping back and forth between the two games. And
so Mayhew will try the same thing and go in and see what Chad does.
Yeah, you're right. And teams will approach this differently. Some people will throw the first one in knowing that the other team's going to throw the corner guard. And then they'll try to guard it up from there.
Some will put it out front first.
What a great shot on G3. If you're one of those people that are watching that game, and I guess if you're hearing me, you wouldn't be, but Kendall Thompson just made about a 15 or 16-foot angle raise takeout for two. Great shot. So up goes the corner guard from Kelly Middlestat. Nice draw by the Mayhew lead. By Nick Burdock. Putting his right on the top of the button. Perfect spot. Gonna throw that shot. Some of these curlers get a little casual with that one and they just let it stop somewhere in the 8-foot or 12-foot or whatever, or they oversweep it a little bit, it goes a foot behind the T line. And you know, it doesn't always play out that it matters, but quite often it makes a difference. So if you have the opportunity to make that shot that much better, you should take that, I think.
It could be the one that counts in the end.
Yeah, I'd rather the person have to outdraw that one that's just about biting the button than outdraw one that's in the 8 foot.
That rock is out there, Jim. I think they learned from Mayhew's guard that didn't work, that they do need a lot of ice there, but that didn't quite curl enough. So
no.
They had to take it in.
Yeah, I don't know if he got out or they just had a little too much room for that. Or
both rocks stayed a little bit out there, but that one really didn't notice if he was wide.
Yeah.
So Chad would like to get both of these rocks, right? Because he doesn't want them to throw another guard on that.
Yeah, he would. I think he'd also settle for getting just the top one and rolling behind the corner.
Behind the corner, yes.
It's a long roll.
He's trying for the two.
Gonna jam it.
Oh, little jam.
Good result for the Stevens team, though. It moved it off the button, moved it over to the 8 foot. Mayhew pretty much has to hit the one that's in the house, so everything's going to be wide open after this shot.
Mm-hmm.
This one could curl a little bit. They have to be a little careful with this. We haven't seen the inside-out shot. I know yesterday in the ladies' game, there was a couple spots where it would curl pretty hard going that way.
Yeah, this is always a terrifying shot.
Yeah.
In my books.
Yeah.
Everyone knows it.
You're like me. You see too much of the, you see too much of bad results after it's done.
Yes.
When you're doing that, what's really called the visualization stuff,
yes.
I think you're not supposed to see bad results.
And there's one.
Yeah.
Oh no, just by.
Yeah.
I think he was a little wide on that.
He was a little wide.
Thought it might curl too much.
Yeah, he might have been doing the same thing we're talking about, where he was envisioning it curling up and jamming it and having a disaster, and just gave it a little extra or put it out a little bit. And
there it goes.
Yeah.
So Chad has a chance to go behind his corner guard.
Yeah, is that what he's going to play?
I think so.
Is he
throwing the out turn?
Yeah. Chad, very aggressive.
Yes. Bring it to him. That is not curling at the moment.
It's most of the curl out here is really at the end. It's really from not too much outside the hog line in. If you throw it well, it runs pretty darn straight for, I don't know, at least 3/4 of the sheet, and then does finish hard like that one. That one's pretty much totally buried and, you know, just outside the hog line, we were thinking it's gonna have to curl a long ways. But it did go too deep and certainly gives Mayhew a chance to come down and sit on it and make it a little tougher for Chad Stevens to develop a deuce there.
This has to be perfect weight, because if he throws too much, it'll hang on that center line for a while.
Yep, true enough. Neil was heavy on his last one, so he'll be, I mean, he threw a hit, but still, you think he overthrew it. So he has to figure it out. Threw that one a little wide, too.
Yes,
he's just now getting to where the broom would have been, but I think it'll be okay for line. Maybe not.
Too bad at all.
Yeah, not too bad. It you know, then that's just the difference of where he was about probably 6 or 8 inches wide, and he just ended up with, you know, probably 4 or 5 inches less curl than he would have liked to have had, but that's pretty good.
So if Chad has back line weight here, he can pop that one just back a bit.
And I don't even know if he's trying or if he's just trying to draw to it, but either way, it's basically the same shot. You just make it with the sweepers.
Right.
He's certainly not heavy.
No, he's not. Could be a good one. Sweepers are remarkable.
Yeah, it's going to overcurl, but so it doesn't lead, doesn't change shot rock situation. Yellow's still sitting too. But there's lots to work with back at the back of the house for Chad Stevens, so not any cause to panic for sure.
Mayhew is lying too.
It's funny, sometimes the numbers are not, don't tell the tale. The last in, He was only ever counting one at any point in that end, and almost, you know, short of missing a last guard, would have stolen one. And here he's sitting two or three, but he really has far less opportunity to steal one.
Yes. Now, Chad, would he not want that to be full eight in the front?
Which team?
Now he's letting Chad come down to it and get his, and be line one.
Yeah, you're right about that. I think he's still thinking a little bit of more defense than offense, really, without the hammer there. And he's just trying to make sure that if he leaves it a little high and leaves it a little open, Chad might make some kind of a double. And all of a sudden,
Yes. You
know, Robert's still sitting one, but Chad might be sitting two, three, four, maybe five.
Yes.
And that gets really scary. So.
So he's sort of playing for the force.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And I know that, you know, Chad still has a chance to develop his two, but really, with the way the setup is here, Robert should be able to hold him to one.
Okay, this is a little heavier than they wanted. Ooh, okay. Good position, though.
Yeah.
Have to overcurl that to get it out cleanly.
Exactly, yeah.
They might not mind if the back one goes. Well, it's,
yeah, you're probably right, since they have... both their yellow ones are closer, so the other one would still remain. So if he gets this out and takes his back one and stays, he'd still sit three, which would be a good position. Yeah, that's good. You can hear that really well.
Yes.
I hear Chris saying, make sure we stick around. I would argue with him that it's not, you know, real. I think it's going to stay. If you cross the face of it, it's going to stay anyway, because it's going to jam on your own.
Yeah, he's got the catcher back there.
Yeah, just don't underthrow this too much, trying to make sure it hangs around and not get and get over there and whack on the guard or something foolish like that.
It's curling. Ooh, it's
the left-hander.
Early.
His intern's going to go.
Pick it out.
Yeah, he's going to be okay.
Ah, good shot.
Yeah, so just as we kind of thought of it there, and too bad we didn't have one of them Telestrator things. We could have drawn it right on there.
Yes.
Chuck, line that up for next year, would you? We'd have a lot of fun with that. So Mayhew sits three, but as we keep saying, even though he does sit three, he's certainly not in steal position, and the Stevens team still thinking about two. They're not really thinking about one right now. Both the two games that we talked about, the team scoring two in the first end, are now tied. So basically we have every game on the sheet after two ends is tied. Either 1-1 or 2-2. So we don't really need to tell anything more than that.
I think they would have preferred that freeze onto that rock. It tapped a little heavily there, Jim.
Can he make the double and not jam it on the back one?
We had that overhead.
There you go.
Let's have a look there.
Those guys are get it for you for sure. I think he can.
I think he can
hit that right on the nose and probably lose all of the blue ones and leave his there. He might sit four or five after this shot.
Mm-hmm. He's going to try it.
The only thing you don't want to do here is you just don't want to jam and leave the blue one and, you know, roll it right to where that broom was. That's where you don't want it to go. Anywhere but that's pretty good.
He has to hit it on the broom side. Right?
Just a hair.
Yeah.
It's really close to a nose hit, and just an inch off of that would be good. Mm-hmm. Taking no ice.
Yes. It's going to be a high, hard one.
Is he ever? That's really little ice, so I'm surprised.
Yes. It hangs on the center line, but it doesn't hang on that in that spot.
It's sometimes hard to relate because the sweepers at this level are so good, and I mean... you know, and they all throw it better than we would throw it too. But even so, even in club when you're playing, you just don't have sweepers at this level. So when you're talking about trying to throw a rock like this, it doesn't even seem possible. I think he's got a great shot. Oh, bad luck.
Yes.
Wow.
Hit it a little too full.
Yeah. Yeah, that's really unfortunate. But the one thing it does is really shows you how those rocks at the back of the house come into play sometimes. It's... you know, really, again, Chad's going to be able to sit two here and have a really good chance of getting a deuce. And and really, really was just manufactured by rock. Too many rocks hanging around.
Mm-hmm. Things change quickly.
I told you a little lie a minute ago. I kind of forgot that the chat had blanked the end on the sheet, so he'd actually, or I was thinking he'd take him one, but he hadn't. So our game is 1-0, but probably all the viewers knew that. And so quite a change around in this end, Sharon. I think it's, for an end that really didn't really look like a deuce, is now looking like a two. And
mm-hmm. So, Jim, he wants to sit and stay right where that yellow rock is, right? He doesn't want to roll over in front of his other, because then there will be an easy, relatively easy double, right?
No, exactly. Hit, stay right there. You could even roll a couple inches to the left as we're looking at it.
Yes.
To the right here on the screen now, but not too much. He wants to be sitting two.
Yeah, he has Kelly sweeping that now, so that try to get it to
trying
curl
to make
a little
it curl,
more.
Yeah.
Yes. Good shot.
Yeah, I think you'll see Robert take a run at the double now. If he had rolled, he had hit it on the nose or rolled a couple inches the other way, then I think he would have just hit the open one and ended up giving up his two.
Mm-hmm.
Now he senses that he might be able to actually get out of this end. He might be able to make the double and force Chad to draw for one.
Yes, he just has to hit it a little over curl and he's throwing the intern, isn't he?
I don't know
what he's throwing.
These guys throw it hard enough. They can probably throw either turn and make the same thing.
Yes, he's probably throwing the out turn. Oh, I think he's throwing the in turn. His curl's too much there for the out
just,
turn.
But he just threw the out turn with on a not that unsimilar shot.
See how he's holding that rock. He's throwing the in turn.
In turn?
Yeah.
So he's planning on being able to back this up a little bit.
Yeah.
And that probably is the case.
Curling.
Both
good.
Guys sweeping, which we don't see much anymore. Will he make it?
He
does.
Beauty.
Great shot. They almost overcooked a little bit. They almost backed it up too far.
Yes, that's a straight spot down there.
But they played a pretty good end. You know, they sort of deserved a force here, and would have been almost a shame for them to give up two after playing a pretty darn good end.
Yes, they did.
So Chad's going to draw for one. Should be pretty close.
Super sweepers. The
boys are working really, really hard on this.
Chad, you can thank the sweepers for that if you make it.
No, he didn't make it.
Oh, he didn't make it. Oh, unfortunate.
Huge miss. Huge miss by Chad Stevens. Robert Mayhew steals two in the third end. Take a 3-0 lead after three ends of play on a pretty simple draw, really. And I'm not quite sure what happened. When I did a split time, and it seemed to me like you should have had enough on that. I'm thinking he must have pulled it back a little bit. And sweepers were, they went hard, but then they kind of almost stopped and then went hard at the end. But so they got caught a little bit, and we'll have to turn it up a notch.
Now we'll see how Mayhew can handle this being up 3-0. He'll put it in the house, Jim, you think? And
absolutely,
then,
yeah.
Then,
he will play, he'll play all defense.
Right.
Yeah.
There'll be lots of hits on the corner guards in this end.
Yeah. So as we mentioned, Chad with number 2 seed coming into this event. Certainly a 3-0 deficit after three ends is not anywhere close to being an insurmountable challenge, but at the same time, you hate to give one away like that. That was a draw to the 8-foot that most of us would think we'd have a good chance of making, and I think Chad would make 19 times out of 20 for sure. So, but give the Mayhew team credit. They played a good end, made all the shots, and we're rewarded. Mayhew lead. Nick Burdock put it back in the exact same place he has been all day, right on the top of the button. He's just had great draw weight. Much easier game when your lead is making those kinds of shots. We talked about that before. It's one of those things, it's like the, you don't notice the lead too much when they're playing well. You notice them a lot when they're not.
Yes.
It's kind of a crappy situation for them. They can play at a bond spiel and the guy can miss three shots and you don't even notice he's there. If he misses three in one game, the roof is falling in.
But when he makes that tick in the last end to clear the front when you have last rock, that's when the lead wins the game.
Yeah, you're right. I hate that shot.
You have to have perfect ice on that, Jim, too.
I know.
Perfect ice and a perfect thrower.
Yeah. So trying to guard up this one in the house, and going to be hard to have this one not over curl, I think. No, they're okay. Just thinking back to the one that Robert threw a couple ends ago and just seemed to keep going.
He wanted that tight, though, and that's pretty tight. That's a good one.
Yep. Right in the center of the Deloitte logo. We're so happy to have Deloitte on board this year as the title sponsor for the men's tankard here at Mayflower. First year for Deloitte, hopefully the first year of many. Have those conversations at the end of the event, I'm sure. Kelly Mittestadt being asked to play the freeze really to the back one, just come around that one and sit on top of it. Like to get it really tight. Kelly made this exact shot a couple of hands ago. Not perfect, but pretty darn good. The leads are doing their job today. Leads have actually had a good game. I don't know if either one of them has missed anything. In turn, I didn't see this one. Sharon, did he call for a guard here, or corner freeze?
Yes,
or?
I was wondering what he was playing. Yeah, I think he, it's pretty guard weight.
Okay.
I think he wants a guard. That's curling too, just like Mayhews did in the second end.
It does appear that you get out there to a certain spot and it does end up curling a little bit more. Because that was the same idea. I think he's just out that a little bit further.
Good guard though.
Yeah, oh yeah, it does a job. I mean, it certainly, I think it's going to force Chad to kind of go up there and try to open this up.
Yeah.
Hate to do it when you're down 3-0, but you don't want to be down 4-0.
No, that's right. He's going to clear that. Hope to get two and roll. Not going to be easy to roll.
You know, we see these shots so much anymore. Yeah, but he can get two here, and he might even be able to get the two front ones and the one in the house if he hits
it
right.
Yes, he could if he hits it on the broom side. Needs a little sweeping.
Yeah, it has to curl more to make the...
There we go. Very good. Nice corner guard. A little close to center line, but a good corner guard.
You can see, though, if that had curled up a little bit more, he may well have been able to bump that blue one right on top of the yellow.
Mm-hmm.
As it is, it's not bad. That's definitely a better situation for Stevens, although there's still that rock that he just threw is not quite a center guard, but it's pretty close. It makes this guard a little bit easier to throw. It doesn't have to be quite so perfect.
Mm-hmm. One side of center line. Be interesting to see how this turn curls.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen any, have we?
No, I don't think we have.
Looks like it's going to curl a lot.
Yeah.
Needs to stop.
Might need a little bounce or a little, or to stop quickly. Mm. Once it hits that center line, it goes sideways.
Yeah, he definitely left his back one exposed. It's too bad because I think you need to err on that one of having a little too much ice.
Mm-hmm.
No, Chad's still going to. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a good call.
Yes.
I thought he might actually go after the one in the back of the, or the top of the button, rather. But he's going to play a little split on his own. Hit number two, number three.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he's not yet. I guess they're still talking about it. He'll show us what he wants to do right there.
Yeah, good call.
Yeah.
I don't know if that would curl up enough to raise that blue onto the yellow. Do you think it would, Jim?
No.
So he's got to play the split or the front.
Yeah, this is going to be
his weight.
Yeah, this is only going to be probably a back 8, back 12-foot weight, so if he ever hits the front, he's not going to do a whole lot of good up there.
Weight looks good.
This is curling pretty hard.
Curling like crazy.
I don't think they're going to get this one by.
No. Oh, so close.
Yeah. Maybe just a hair light, actually, looking at where it went. It was probably T-line back 4 foot weight, but I don't think it was really quite enough weight to pull that off.
No.
But it did open it up, and it does force Mayhew to make a better guard.
Taking a little more ice.
Chris McCray, left-hander. Traditionally in curling, interns seem to curl more than outturns. I think that's a pretty fair statement, and this is Chris's intern, so he'll have to make sure he has enough room.
A little tight, maybe. Weight's good.
Yeah, I think it looks pretty good. It's definitely going to curl. You know it's going to curl, so you don't have to really worry about that. Got to close that hole. Go a little more yet, I think. That should be pretty darn good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, great shot. Good sweeping, too. They had to work pretty hard to get it there. Made it right to the AMJ Campbell logo, one of our Nova Scotia Curling Association sponsors. They sponsor the under-21 championships, and they also are responsible for moving our rocks all over the province for us, which is really a nice sponsorship to have. It's as most people know, freight is expensive these days, and to try to ship 64 curling stones that weigh 40 pounds a piece?
Yes.
I don't know, would that be a little over a ton? All I know is it would be a lot of money.
It would be a lot of money. Yeah.
I know it was $300 to ship one set from here to New Glasgow, so I think it would be an insurmountable challenge for
us. A good sponsor. Us.
Yeah, a great sponsor, yeah. And they sponsor at the national level. They're involved in curling all the way across the country, so nice to see us have them on board here in Nova Scotia as well. Uh-oh.
Ooh. Let's get it over there.
Yeah. Okay. That's a good result for the Stevens team, because it makes, it certainly causes some grief for Mayhew. Now he's looking at having to make some perfect guards or face maybe a two or a three here.
Indeed.
I think you still have to play the same shot. I think you're committed here. I really think you have to throw the guard. And
that blue one, the blue on the forefoot is, Stevens rock is buried.
I don't really like that call. Guys might take a minute to think about this one. This is a big call. This is a big point in the game.
We hear what they have to say.
Yeah.
We can hear them.
I think they would love to have one less blue rock in the house. And that would be great, but it's just not easy to do here, because to get rid of one of those blue ones and hang around and not have Chad have just basically an open, free whack at getting two, is really tough. So a little timeout call by the Mayhew team here. Mm-hmm. Take 90 seconds. Coach of the team is Robert's father, Alan, I think, and I assume he'll go out with them. Some of the coaches go out, some of them don't. These players have played so much and at such a high level that sometimes the coach is there for more off-ice management of feelings and chores and practices and all that. But no, coach is out here. Have a little chat.
So the question is whether to throw the guard or make a double on that front and at least get rid of the front one there, Jim?
Yeah, I think the double's really hard. I don't think you'd ever try to make the double, because I think if you do, you're going to run a risk of hitting your own, or if you hit it too thin, if you try to make the double across the high side, in other words, across the top of the rock, you're going to roll out if you do make it, and it's really hard. So I think it'll be a case of more getting rid of one blue, maybe sitting number one, number three. Mm-hmm. And the only thing I don't like about it, again, is that it just gives Chad just an open hit to sit two. And I know you have a 3-0 lead, so giving up two is not something that you're not expecting. But I think you have a great situation. I think if you can throw a guard out here, then you have a really good chance of maybe even stealing another point or making Chad's shot so difficult.
And that's what they're doing.
Yeah. You just have to make it.
Yeah, sometimes teams are too aggressive. I probably would have tried that double and raised it up onto the yellow one.
Don't get stop that negative thought thing. You gotta start playing the shots that you think you're gonna make.
Even cornering that blue would be okay, but they're going to play the long.
It
yard,
would,
I guess.
But that you know that's I saw Chris put his broom down there and say, well, right here it'd be nice, but yeah. It's nice if you don't bump it like 8 inches because you set up a double. So, I think the guard's the right call, and I think that they've made it a lot of times here, and they just have to make it three more times and walk away with a point maybe.
He has the weight.
It just has to not overcurl.
Better over and off.
Yeah, I get a
get
stop.
Get it over. Ooh, just. Does the trick.
Well, it does. I still think you can come around the top one and get rid of the yellow one myself. Really difficult shot, but I think you can do that.
Okay.
See here on the shot, we'll just have a chance he moves out of the way.
Yes.
It's tough, but I think it's makeable. Why you try to get rid of more rocks? Do we did the last time, hit the yellow on the blue, on the yellow and have the blue roll in the house somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think you can do it this time. I think the lines are, the angles just aren't right. But you get rid of a couple here and force Mayhew to make the guard with no help on either side. Mm-hmm. All of a sudden it's much, much harder. Sometimes when you have a couple of guards on one side that aren't guarding the rock, but they make it a whole lot easier for you to throw yours because you can actually leave a hole as long as you don't leave it wider than 13 inches or whatever, however wide the rock is.
Mm-hmm.
Cameron McKenzie throwing a peel of some sort here. I think he's going to hit it.
He's trying for the back one.
He wasn't. Whoa.
That was too bad.
That's kind of disaster for the Stevens team. Cameron just might have did a little something with it, overthrew it or whatever.
A little outward motion, I think.
Yeah.
Weight, too. Maybe he might get that yellow one in the back, but unfortunately bad things happened.
These logos are great for placement of rocks. It gives us something to kind of talk about, too. So it's kind of nice when you can just say, well, throw it up there above the L and Delight or on the
Put
O
it on
and
the
Delight.
L. Yes.
Yeah, probably fits perfectly on the O and Delight, so that would be a nice spot, but not for now, but sometime later. So he's trying to block the draw here is what he's trying to do, is block Chad's outturn draw. Chad might play the run back on the blue, but that's a hard shot. Chris signaled it had lots of weight.
So if it curls up enough and he can...
Well, that's a good shot. I'm not sure that it... I'm not sure it really takes away the draw, but it still does take away... It adds another rock to the mix out there.
Yes.
So.
So will Chad clear the front this time?
Well, I don't know that he has any choice. I don't really know.
He's got to clear something.
He could play the same draw. He could play that outturn draw around the one that Robert just threw. Possible. He could, if he wanted to, take a run at that blue on the blue, and if you ever make it, you're going to sit two or three. The only problem with it at all, if there's a problem, is that if you don't make it, you really are going to have a little on your next one, but... I think that's the same with any shot right now.
Yes. Chad is behind the eight ball right now.
Yeah. At least if you play this one, maybe you open up both sides. You force Robert maybe to throw one back there and gives you the outturn draw. I don't know. But he might have an option, whereas if he tries the draw and doesn't make it, he may not have any option.
So he needs a true nose hit on that blue right now. Right on the nose.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe. I don't know if that's the way he's playing it or if he'll play it a little high side and try to go blue on blue. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Hit the blue high blue one on the other blue one.
Uh-oh.
May not matter.
Okay,
it looks
yes.
like he's going to be on the inside.
I see. Yeah. Okay.
Ooh. I'm not sure he threw that one real well.
No, I think he was a little in.
Yeah, it seemed like it was gone really early.
Yeah.
So now you have a decision. If you're Mayhew, you decide, well, do you want to guard that raise, the one that Chad just tried, Or do you draw guard this outturn draw? I think I'm going to guard the raise because if I'm going to guard, I think I'm guarding the raise. The outturn draw is for one.
Yes,
that raise is for two
is
or
for
three.
Yes.
Or you just go right in. I suppose you could play a real aggressive play. Might be to just throw the outturn draw right around, put it in the right beside the other one.
Right.
That'd be a pretty good spot.
Yeah. Even top, yes, top eight.
Yeah, be number two, and might as well be full
put
eight
it,
and make
yes.
sure.
Put the force for
a little more heat on. And that would actually take away the raise takeout, too, because if he plays it then, it's only from one. So, you know, I think some players, some skips certainly would say, well, heck, I'm just going to go right out of here. I'm going to go right around. Because you're not like you're leaving yours wide open. You know what I mean? If you play the outturn draw, the other one, he's still got to make this, whatever that is, 12-foot raise takeout.
He
can go around it on this side, too.
If he wanted to come, yes. He's playing for the front of it, but...
Yeah, he is, yeah. Be careful you don't line these up, so it's just kind of...
That's the nightmare.
Too easy. That's a nice shot.
Looks good, yes.
Nice shot. Well, maybe a little more defensive. Maybe the score dictates that a little bit, too. You know, you're already up 3-0.
Yes, and Chad hasn't... Well, he didn't make his last draw, so...
This one's a lot harder.
This is a lot harder. Yeah. And we're out in ice that hasn't been used all that much.
Yep.
I think it's a little heavier out there myself.
I'll tell you, you know what? It might be just the opposite, Sharon.
Think?
I know it's only the fourth end. Yeah, put a watch on this one. But I know certainly later on in the game when you get to that 7-8 ends, then if you go out on the new ice, sometimes it's quicker than down the center. It happened in the Connor game yesterday. Nancy had to draw for two in the last end. She had to go out on brand new ice. And
a little
just
more
threw
in it
to, yeah, just she didn't add more because I talked to them afterwards, but it was quicker. It was a half a second quicker out there, and just slid to the back of the 12-foot.
Now I got 3-6-6 on that back line to Hog.
3-6-6, yeah.
Yes, and that is heavy.
Yeah,
that's
that
heavy
should be
ice.
Heavy. So you looks like you might
I
be right.
I don't know. I don't want to be right here, but I'd like to keep the game interesting.
Well, I don't think it's getting there.
No, but so just a little more weight, and he had it. Beautiful line.
Yeah. So you're right on that one for sure. So another point for Robert Mayhew. And Mayhew leads 4-0 over Chad Stevens here. After four ends of play at the Deloitte Tanker, draw number two for the men. First of two games for all the men's team today. Men's teams today. Actually, everybody plays two games today, so men and women. Long day here at the Mayflower Club. But we're pleased to be here and pleased to be bringing you the game on Bell Alliant TV 1. Takes a lot of sponsors to put all these events on, and you can see on the boards here sometimes when you're in the club, you can see that AMJ Campbell's there, and as they are in the ice, and you've got Kruger with Scotty's brand on the ladies' side, supporting curling for what seems like about 100 years now, but it's been a long time, been probably 30-some. Quality Concrete, major sponsor of this year's event as well, and others. So no change in the game plan for Mayhew. Throw it in there, let Chad throw the corner guard, and then work it from there.
Another perfect rock from the Mayhew team.
Exciting day yesterday here with the women playing two games and a few upsets along the way. Certainly, Mary Mattistall's team went 2-0 yesterday, knocking off a couple teams that would have been ranked well above them. All the teams are great teams here, so it's not a real shock when somebody wins a game, but to go 2-0 for that team and with the draw that they had was a great start. Puts them in a really good position going on to the rest of the week. Marianne Arsenal went 2-0 but did have two squeakers, two games that were kind of nail biters and could have went either way. Jill Brothers went the hands-on favorite, I think, and defending champion went 1-1 yesterday, winning their first game and before losing to Mary Mattall in their second game. I think Mary stole the last end to win that game, but some of the other teams have a little work to do to get back in it. Teams that might have started 0-2 or 1-1 and need to get going. Julie McAvoy had a good day. Went 1-1, I think it was, but played two great games and won her first one and could have won her second one.
So Chad's asking for a little tap back on this. He wants rocks at the back of the house to set up a fence.
Yeah, that almost should, well, almost worked for him in the third end. He ended up giving up two, but but it did. He had the potential to get two in that end, so no need to change anything much up from that. He certainly doesn't want to remove this rock. Some of the other big sponsors that we have here this week are the main sponsors, gold sponsors, gold level sponsors, include 40 Creek Whiskey Company and Advanced Systems. We thank those guys for being on board. And we'll give you a few of the others as we go along here. So good shot there.
Yeah, good shot by Kelly.
Yeah. Nice thing for Robert with a 4-0 lead. He actually doesn't have to think this one out too much. It's just let's go out and get rid of the guard. Just have a look across the board here. We've got Stuart Thompson's game with Mike Fleming all tied up at 4-4. Kendall Thompson scored 2 in the fourth to take a 4-3 lead over Paul Dexter. And Brett McDougall, after getting 2 in the third against defending champs, Jamie Murphy did give up 3 in the fourth and trail 4-3 going into 5. Our game, as we said, 4-0 after 4. Sounds like a lopsided affair. Really not, really hasn't been. And I would expect it to get much closer as the game goes on.
So Stevens is using that corner guard now. He has to draw whenever possible.
Yeah, go around the guard and then try to figure out how to get rid of the yellow one a little later on.
This is that spot that we saw so much of in the third end. Gonna make it? Nice shot.
Yeah, good shot. Again at the back though, you know, last time, where did it go through? No.
No, it's there.
That, ideally you want that rock to be much higher. You'd like that rock to be just above the tee line.
Yes. They were sweeping it to make it curl, I guess, but they probably could have stopped a little earlier.
You know, Lampy asked to remove the Stevens rock on the top of the forefoot.
Has to curl a little more. That worked out well.
Yeah, that's a good shot. Ended up with a reverse freeze at the back of the house. I learned what the term reverse freeze meant yesterday from Selena Thompson.
Reverse freeze.
Yeah, and then they demonstrated the last night during the late game when I was home. So I think that Selena is the only person that actually uses that term, but I think it's a good one. So we're going to adopt it.
Short.
Yeah, not a good shot.
3-8. Got 3-8 on that.
That's two really not too good of shots for Ian. Ian would expect to make better shots than that. His first one went to the back of the house, and that one comes up short. So
You could even tap it at the back and still be okay.
Be better than there for sure.
Yeah. So Mayhew is going to guard.
Yeah, guard or a little tap? I'm not sure.
Yeah, let's see what he plays here. Yeah, a tap would be better, wouldn't it, Jim?
Well, I mean, I don't
He's
know.
He's up 4-0. He doesn't want to.
Yeah, I mean, if you could put this guard right on the O in Deloitte, we'd be pretty darn good. I don't think that would be a bad shot at all, and certainly takes away. If you do tap it, you know, you do give Chad the chance to roll behind the guard again, which would be which would be not a good thing. So it looks like obviously they were playing the straight guard. It's a great guard, perfect. It's, you know, see Chad standing on the back, kind of rubbing the beard a little bit, thinking what he's got to do to make things happen here. Really doesn't want to be peeling any more guards. He's down 4-0. The last thing he wants to do is start wasting away rocks, getting rid of front rocks, but I'm not sure he can afford to not do that. But throw this in here, throw the intern. He's talking about throwing the intern, sort of freeze tap on the yellow, and maybe if he can do that, you can set up a little bit of an angle slash kind of shot to perhaps get a multiple score later on in the end.
Move that rock out from the 4 foot out into this into the open, considering the hit on the front.
Yeah, you can see there, that's a good angle at that shot. You can see Chad looking at, well, if we can hit it thin, maybe we can hit it thin enough we can slide one of the other blue ones into the house, which would be good. It's a pretty thin shot to do that, I think. Cameron McKenzie throwing it down there, and Cameron making sure he doesn't throw it wide. Had a little trouble that last end, but almost. Good thought, though. You know, if he hits it just a hair thinner, maybe half an inch or three quarters of an inch thinner, he probably does. Certainly moves them around and might move the blue one in, if not in the house, but much closer that he can use it later. But it didn't happen, so.
Just by inches.
Yeah, so they're in trouble. Stevens team, and now we're down to the third second shot. I think we are. No, first shot. Oh no, second shot, he's yellow, that's right. So we're down to the third second stone and getting late in the end. Looks like another guard, perfect guard.
Perfect guard.
I'd say that's gotta be, if we had like the ability to do a replay, I think it's exactly the same. It's really close to being the exact same spot.
Yes.
I'm a little disappointed, I was really looking for it to end up on the O, but it didn't. So we're just a couple of shots away from the fifth end break here, and the Stevens team might have to do some regrouping at the break. They are going to be hard-pressed to score two here. They might be hard-pressed to score one if they don't make a good one here. Cameron McKenzie needs to come up with a big shot for his team here. Chad indicated he might have been a hair wide. Just saw the arm go up just to let the sweepers know.
It'll curl at the end.
Yeah, it will.
Here it goes.
Looks like a pretty good shot, yeah.
Yes.
That was if there was a danger at all with that shot, it was that you were probably going to end up tapping it back and sitting wide open. So that's what happened, but you can't, you know, you got to still play it and hope you either roll to the behind the guard, one of the guards. Doesn't even matter which one. But it had to move. It was too good of a rock to leave there, and nice shot by Cameron. He did all he could do with it. At the end of the day, they're going to need a little bit of a break here to get a two.
So he wants a nose hit here or pop in behind that corner guard?
He probably doesn't really
either
care
one,
too much.
Either one will work.
I think a nose hit might be better, actually, because if Chad makes a play on the back one and rolls behind, you'd have your own to run into it. And more importantly, I think the nose hit might be possible. I don't know if you try to go for the roll behind the guard that you don't end up hitting the guard.
Uh-oh. Ooh.
Feathered it a little bit, straightened it up here. That's just pretty precise calling, I think, on that shot.
Yes.
Yeah. We have a little bit of family up here on the Mayhew side, so not a big crowd for an 8 o'clock in the morning game, but I think they have the opposition outnumbered 2-1. More people downstairs. The main seating area is downstairs, and then certainly if you buy a weekly pass, that's where you're going to sit. And some great seats down there, sort of bleacher seating, but not like typical bleachers with nice seats and nice cushiony seats and all that kind of stuff. So it's... like I say, at 8 o'clock in the morning game, you have to be a pretty good fan to be here at the Curling Club or be related. But anyway, so far, Mom's happy, so we'll go with that.
4-0. Mom should be happy.
So Chad, yeah, go ahead.
I'm sorry, Jim. Chad is electing to hit here and roll in behind the corner guards.
I don't think corner guard. I think he has to go roll behind that center guard.
Behind the center, okay.
Yeah, I just don't think there's enough room to roll behind the corner. So still has a chance here, you know. If he makes a good roll here and Robert does anything, makes any kind of small error on his shot, Chad will have a chance for his two.
Watch it closely. Curls at the end.
I think they lost it.
Yeah, I think they did. How far is it going? Okay. Good spot.
Yeah, it's one of those that I think you you kind of look like you know what you're doing, but I think that was a pretty bad mistake. I think they were very fortunate not to lose that rock or have that rock sit in that same hole that was there before.
And it curled.
Yeah. So now Robert's got to make a nice little draw down here through the port. And if he can get it down there anyway, anywhere at all, he's going to hold Chad to one or maybe even steal one. Chad hasn't really quite found the draw weight yet. I would expect him to be close, but.
So, Jimmy wouldn't want to take more ice and draw behind the yellow, his own, and go to the button.
You could. No reason why you couldn't, to be honest. It's. You know, if you get through here at all, then there's going to be no opportunity for Chad to do anything with it because it's going to be sitting right on his own. So I think the thinking might be that if you go the other way and, you know, if you go a little deep or it doesn't curl quite enough or whatever, then he will have a chance for his two. But nothing wrong with that at all. And actually, if you left it out a little bit, left a little bit of the edge showing on the outturn side around that center one, it'd be pretty tough for Chad to remove it. But Robert's had a great game so far, so we'll see if he can keep it up.
Keep this from curling too much.
I think he looks okay to me, but.
Gets it by that front, he's good, and it's by.
Wow, great
beautiful
shot.
Beautiful shot, that was not an easy shot. That was a beautiful shot. Front of the tee, just behind.
I'm not quite sure why they didn't keep sweeping that. If that stops, I don't know, a few inches shorter, there might have been a double off of this yellow one out here. It's a little bit iffy whether or not you would have been able to get enough curl without hitting the blue one, but there's nothing wrong with sweeping that another couple of inches and making sure. But anyway, it worked out good, so they're fine. Chad now will play he's going to actually try to move this. I guess that's the other reason why it might not have been bad to take it a little bit further, but tough shot to move it, I think. Robert went through there with just T-line weight.
Yes.
And Chad's going to have to be back 12 probably to make this shot. Pretty close to back 12. Tough shot.
That is a really tough shot.
But you know what? It's probably no harder than the straight draw, to be honest. So if you're going to try a tough shot, you might as well be for two rather than one. Nice shot, though. Team's playing well today.
It is a tough shot. Anxious to see what he's. This could be the shot of the game. He's got tap weight. Watch it, it's gonna curl.
He's close, he's gonna be close.
Will it make it by?
I think so. No, maybe not.
Yes.
But has he got the angle right?
Oh,
wow, that's
beautiful.
A terrific shot.
Beautiful shot.
Chad Stevens with just a pistol of a shot here in the fifth end, really making a two from nothing and right back in the game. It's just, you know, it's a game of inches, as we say. He went from maybe ticking a guard and being down 5-0 to being down 4-2. Big difference. So great shot by Chad Stevens, and at the fifth end break, Mayhew continues to lead, playing really solid this morning at the 4-2 lead. We're going to take a little short break, grab a Tim Hortons or whatever, and we'll be back here in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Thank you. So here we are in the sixth end after Stephen's beautiful tap back takeout. Ooh, that could have been a mishap there. To take two in the fifth. So now it's Chad's turn to try to steal. And so he's drawing. He's electing to put his rock in the front. So since Mayhew is up two, rather than a corner guard, he's going right in the house. Teams have beautiful draw weight.
Yeah, for sure. It's the ice is so nice, and these guys have such nice deliveries that draw weight shouldn't be a big problem.
Nope. Except when you're the skip and you're drawing for last rock. And
yeah, I know. I know that feeling.
So Stevens wants to go around this now, right to the button. Where is he going?
He's probably
he's
second
playing
guard.
The front. He's playing the front again. Yes, good call. He really needs to steal this end.
Yeah, that was a terrific shot, though, by Chad. It'd be nice to see that one again sometime. That was a heck of an effort to make that shot. And
yes.
I think Robert's team will probably take a little something away from that and realize that they could have made that shot just a little better. But anyway, they still have a 4-2 lead after five, playing the six with Hammer, and I'm pretty near positive that they would have been quite happy with that when they went out at 8 o'clock this morning.
So Jim, he's playing the tick here.
Yep.
A little bit more difficult on our ice than it is when you see it on TV.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure why they weren't sweeping that, I guess. I don't know. I thought they'd probably sweep that and keep it a little straighter and, yeah.
Little communication problem.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Maybe they thought it would cross over or something like that. Mm-hmm. Anyway, it hardly matters. He'll be throwing a bunch of peels here in a minute. Chad's going to hit the one in the house and try to roll over, but you'll see Robert's team come out and start whacking away there after that. Mm. So all close games this morning out here. This is actually the biggest difference in games is on our sheet with a 2-point spread. We've got one tie game out there with McDougal and Murphy are all tied up after five. Murphy having Hammer in six. And Fleming leads Thompson 5-4. Thompson with Hammer in six. And Paul Dexter leads Kendall Thompson 5-4. Kendall had last rock in the six. So close games this morning. No big surprise coming into this event. You know, you always have a couple of teams that have had a little better years, maybe seed a little higher, but there's no weak links out here. Every team out here is quite capable of beating everybody. It's not a stretch at all for virtually anybody to come out of this event this weekend, or when the weekend gets here.
Stephen's going to guard again. He'll continue to guard. Beauty, right on the tee for Deloitte. So Mayhew would like to get the two of them this time.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely need to get rid of both. Because the high one's not really hurting you right now, so if you only get it, it's not really a real productive situation. He's going to be real close, I think.
He's real close. Ooh, good shot.
Yeah, terrific shot.
Fantastic.
Absolutely perfect. Now you've got two corner guards. There's one blue one in the house, but that's all there is. And Chad's forced to throw a center guard and leave the blue one open and completely changed around that end.
Neil
will be happy with that one. Yeah, change. That's what you keep saying. You know, it really is. It really does change quite often on one shot. And two shots at the most can totally swing an end around. We saw that in the last end, really. Mm-hmm. You know, Robert got in a little trouble after the first hit and roll for Stevens and made a pretty darn good shot. And then Chad makes a great shot, gets two. And changed hands about three times in the last three shots.
So Mayhew is going to try the double again. Take out on the blues.
Nice double to throw, too, because no real risk here. Like, you're going to be playing the double, and if you don't make it, you're still going to get rid of the center guard, which is nice. Sometimes when you're playing a double and you're hitting one close to the center, you run the risk of leaving it there.
This looks like it's curling, so may not have two.
Close.
Oh, close. He did. Got them. Beauty. Wow. I could see that one in the house.
Yeah.
Beauty. So Chad will continue to put the rocks in the center line out front.
Yeah, the Mayhew team has really bounced back after, like I said yesterday, certainly a slow start to yesterday's game, but they did tighten up and make a game of it. So maybe just that, you know, first half, first game, a little bit of jitters, a little bit of newness to the event and all that kind of stuff. And they sure aren't showing any signs of being off in this game. They've just played really, really well. And Cameron McKenzie just rifling this one through.
Ooh.
The house.
Short is good. Long is not.
That's
unfortunate.
Yeah. Usually when you throw one like that, it's really a mental miss more than anything else. It just kind of just didn't have your head in the right place when you threw it. Sometimes you get a little misinformation, or you yourself develop some misinformation, but not sure that was the case. So the intern come around now. You got a great situation for Mayhew. As he looks to maybe get that deuce back, he's got two corner guards to work with and no center guards, no blue rocks in play. I don't think you could draw it up any better. Don't want this to be too deep. And looks like it will be.
Mm-hmm. So.
Well, the good news is it's deep enough that even if Chad makes it, freezes on it, he'll still have the same shot.
Yes. So, see how Chad throws his draw. He could do a little tap.
Yeah, I don't think he even wants to. If he taps it, it's a mistake because he doesn't want to be back there.
He'd like to be front, like mid, full eight behind that corner.
Yeah, and as you said, the last end, definitely this time above the tee line for Chad. Don't want to allow Robert a chance to come down and play the same draw and maybe have a real good chance of getting two. He's going to have to curl a long way. This one looks pretty heavy, too.
Yes, it does. They were sweeping.
This will dig in probably, but it's a little bit heavy.
Yep. They were sweeping for tee line, I guess, and that's what it is.
Yeah. Just might have got it out a little tiny bit, or just a smidge too much weight. You just didn't curl quite as much as you would have liked, obviously. So Robert's got a good chance here. He can hit this. If he hits this if he hits it on the nose and just sort of maybe flops a couple inches to the right as we look at it on the screen, then it would be a pretty good shot. Even a nose hit's a good shot here.
So he's throwing inside the center line. We'll see if this takes off or not.
Yeah,
might have been a little inside. Looks good. He makes it by. Yes.
Well swept.
Beauty.
Nice shot. Nothing wrong with that. Just he went at that a little more weight than I thought he was going to throw. I thought maybe he might have thrown it a little bit lighter, but 4-2 lead. You don't maybe want to fool around a whole lot. Pick the weight that you're comfortable with and throw it, and he did. So a very nice shot.
So Chad needs the roll on this, right?
Chad, yeah. Nose hit here doesn't help Chad a whole lot.
No.
Not going to get the roll behind the guard. Be an open hit, I think.
Trying for the two.
Wow. Ouch.
Ouch is right.
Yeah. So he definitely wasn't trying for the two with that weight, but at one point, I guess maybe they thought they might, and anyway, they ended up with a freebie hit for three for Robert Mayhew. Take your time with this one. This is a big shot. Shot of the game here. This pretty much solidifies your lead and puts you in a great position going into the last four ends. So you definitely need to take some time. Make sure you make contact first of all. Be nice to stay for sure, but even contact's pretty good. Robert's throwing him good today. I wouldn't expect him to have too much trouble with this shot. It looks fine. Let's curl a little more to make sure it stays.
Yes.
Might not stay.
Nope. Yes. Here it goes.
Great shot.
Good shot.
So a big three spot for Robert Mayhew after Chad really taking a two-ender in the last end. He didn't really give it to him. He made pretty good shots. Chad just made a heck of a shot. And Robert just comes down and makes a good one on his first. Good one on his second one. Picks up three and now takes a commanding 7-2 lead into the seventh end. Mayhew squad, as I've said a couple times, just having a great game here today, playing very, very well. Stevens team obviously not 100% on, but really when the other team's playing really well, sometimes it's tough.
It puts the pressure on you, and now the Stevens team has to really get together and keep their spirits up and dig deep.
Yep.
So he's going to put this rock on the button.
Yeah, and he's done that perfect every time since we've seen it, the game start, basically. Every rock has been top button, so it'll be interesting to see if he keeps that streak alive here. A little tiny bit harder now because you know you don't want to be short, but at the same time, it's usually when you're zeroed in on that weight, you kind of hold on to it. This one not curling very much, actually.
There's a little ridge out there or something. It stays out a while if you have any weight on it.
Yeah, I think he had one of them a couple hands ago, too, actually. Mm-hmm. We talked about it, and I think he helped. I think it's partly the way he throws it. He helps it out there a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And just a little too much weight to get the break.
Yeah. So Chad needs the corner guards now.
Yeah, Chad's all offense now. There's not. He's either going to get in it or he's going to get out of it here in another end or two. Usually these games, they're going to get real close or they're over in about two more ends, so we'll see how this one goes. Certainly lots of talent out there, lots of capable shot-making abilities, and they know how to generate offense, so we'll see how they get along. So I'll just do a little update again here. What do we have? Stuart Thompson picked up two in the sixth end. He leads now 6-5 over Mike Fleming. In their game, Kendall Thompson, I guess the other two games really haven't, they've just got a couple shots left to throw in the sixth end, so we'll come back to that in a few minutes. Can't tell you, Brent McDougall's got Jamie Murphy in some serious trouble over here with one rock to come in that end in a tie game. Jamie's looking at two, and Not quite sure how he's going to get in there, but. So Kelly Middlestadt, see Robert Mayhew, they played the draw around that corner guard. That's one way to defend the corner guard, is to kind of beat the team around it. It's just a little bit dangerous sometimes. It's didn't have a lot of choice here. He doesn't want to have to throw guard, so. And he threw it perfect. Just don't want to slide to the back of the house or even the tee line. Up goes the corner guard. Kelly, no problem throwing two corner guards.
Even with the other one, beautiful weight.
Yeah, perfect shot.
Now the hits begin.
Neil Gallant. Boomer weight, peel. Looks pretty good. Ooh. Neil's just a little guy, weighs probably about 85 pounds. And he kind of comes out of there a little bit like a, I don't know what, just a different delivery for sure, but gets the job done and has no problem throwing it hard. So a real good shot there, you're right, got rid of both corner guards.
Yeah, that was
I didn't even think that was possible.
No, I didn't either.
You told me they were dead even.
I thought they were dead even, but he hit it on the side, Jim, and rolled in.
All right. Let's put the glasses back on, maybe. Anyway, it was a heck of a shot. So another corner guard goes up for Team Stevens.
He's going to freeze to that?
Well, maybe he is. Yeah, I don't know if that was a call or it was. Maybe they did play that. I don't know. It sort of looked like. Yeah, maybe they did. It's probably a good shot. I'm not sure the blue one can go anywhere. Actually, it can't go anywhere because you can hit it as hard as you want and all that's going to go is your own. Which I think probably is still the better shot. If I were him, I'd think hard about playing that. Just hit it, get rid of the yellows out of the way, and roll yours over and. Front of your other one somewhere.
Yes, get rid of it later.
I know it's only number 3, but I'll be a little surprised if they don't end up doing something with it. But they're feeling the offense today, so.
Yes.
I'm going to go with the guard, sort of a guard in the house guard, whatever you call that shot. So I didn't see Jamie's last shot, but I didn't know how he was ever going to score, and sure enough, he didn't. Brent McDougall stole 2 in the 6th end to take a 6-4 lead after 6 in that game. Brent coming off really not a great effort yesterday either. A couple teams had rocky starts yesterday and really hanging tough here and with the lead over the defending champs with 4 ends to go. And Paul Dexter stole 1 in his game that had pretty near every rock, I think, in play on that sheet. And there was 1 blue one right on the button, guarded by about 14 other rocks. And Kendall tried to blast something out of there and didn't happen. He stole 1. Paul Dexter leads 6-4 over Kenda Thompson after 6. And that's it. Now updated.
So, Jim.
Yeah.
Mayhew's team went deep. Back of the 4 foot yep. with that guard and the 12 foot, which was not very good. And so now Chad's come down to it.
Yeah,
freezing
big mistake.
To it. Yeah.
Yes. Big mistake by Mayhew and a big mistake here by Team Stevens. Ian's struggled a little bit the last few ends, and he just kind of put that in a pretty easy place to get rid of it. You had a lot of backing there. You had to get it somewhere in front of those. But it's really not. It's a little bit in front of one of them, but the way these guys can heave it down there, it shouldn't be a problem getting rid of it. Probably will take one of the back ones with him. I think he'd want to. But doesn't.
No.
So Chad still with some stuff to work with. He's still got the same shot, the same freeze, and if you get it in there, you may be able to put it somewhere where it won't go. It won't go away on one shot, with one shot.
He gets it right between the two. Be perfect. You're pretty casual with the sweeping right now, so they must feel it's heavy. It's hanging on that little ridge.
Yeah, a little heavy and has to curl.
Here it comes. Per, that's lovely.
That's a great shot,
that's
yep.
A good one.
So what tells us two things. One is it was a great shot, and secondly, we can't really go by what the sweepers look like because they look like they had given up on that
yes.
about 20 feet from when it stopped. Yeah, dandy shot. Chris just trying to figure out whether or not it'll go. I'm guessing it'll probably go. Maybe we can get that overhead shot again for a second, and we'll see if it... it's pretty tough, eh?
Over-curl it. The back one goes, yeah. And the blue goes.
So I think the plan here really probably is a nose hit. So thanks for that in the booth. The command center. This one's going to have to do a little bit of curling, or he's just going to get rid of all of his own.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's probably what was going to happen no matter what, so that's fine. He really need to unlock that, loosen it up at the back there, and make sure he could get rid of it on the next shot.
So is Chad going to play the guard? Or go in behind something?
No, he's not going to guard, that's for sure. He's going to be going in somewhere. He's just trying to figure out when he can.
That.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to figure out when he can play that shot because it's. And I think they've called a timeout here now. Yeah, they have. So they've called a timeout to talk about this one. It's a tough call. I mean, he can play that hit on the one that he froze with, the one at the top of the 12 foot, and can certainly be sitting. I don't know, sitting 1-3 maybe, or 1-2 and. 4 or something like that. Anyway, he could have 3 rocks in play and with the potential of scoring after the shot, but has to be careful he doesn't run it back.
Yes, on that, the yellow one to the blue,
yeah.
That's in the 4 foot.
I don't think it will, because I think if he hits it on the, what are we looking at it? So with that view, if he hits a little bit on the left side as we look at it, it will actually drag the yellow one a little bit away from the one in the back
mm-hmm.
of the button.
It'll pick up the other turn and go by.
Yeah, and it will even, so it'll just drag it back there. So that would be okay, and then he would sit number 1, probably number 2, and like I said, number 4, the yellow one at the back will be 3. But then you're only one half shot away from maybe being able to get a 3-ender. So
mm-hmm.
that would probably be not a bad call at this point, because if you don't soon make a play on that, you're just not going to be able to bring it into play. So if you're hoping to be able to get that blue one at the top to count, probably now is the time.
Okay, so this is Cameron's second shot.
Big shot. Cameron made a nice one on his first one. He needs to make another nice one here.
And he can throw the weight.
Yeah. And you don't actually have to throw this one super hard, I don't think. I think you can make this with...
Yes, it's pretty straight there,
yeah. So. Just be a matter of how far you want your shooter to roll. I guess you'd like it to roll 6 or 7 feet or so to get it over to the right-hand side somewhere, but...
Yeah, just good control.
I didn't think they'd play this turn, to be honest. I thought they'd play the other turn.
Yes.
Ooh. He's not going to make this.
Okay. Well, okay, it's still hanging around, but with two other yellow rocks in the house, I don't know.
But you know what? It hung around, and it might outcount the yellow one that's at the front of the house. If it does that, then it's a great shot, because then you have the same scenario we just talked about. You'd have 1, 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's yellow, then it didn't help quite as much, but... Regardless, he's got himself in a position to maybe have a chance at 3 and certainly have a chance at 2, because if Robert makes this shot, it's going to be hard to roll where Chad can't take a whack at the double. But continue. He's throwing a lot of takeouts with no ice today.
Yes.
It's like I don't quite know how he's doing that. He doesn't seem to be throwing them that hard, but just anyway, he just got to figure it out. It must be the way he throws, and he understands how he throws. And
he's pretty well.
This
on
one's
the
a little
there.
Firm. Yep.
It's curling.
Don't want to lose the back one if you can possibly help it. This could be perfect.
Oh, looks good.
If it jams on the other. And it does. Great
shot. Beautiful shot. Beautiful shot.
You know, that's what Neil signaled that when he, with his broom, when they were talking about it down there. I just thought that was maybe a little tiny bit optimistic, but great shot. Roberts had a terrific game. Just really played very, very well.
So Chad's going to freeze down to that back one.
Yeah, you don't have a lot of choice now. You freeze to the back one and hope you make a perfect freeze, and then Robert will either get rid of the front one, the one at the top of the 12, or follow you right down, which would probably take your end away if he makes it perfect. But you need a miss. Like, you're going to need a miss here even to get two, because he didn't even, with that shot that Robert Mayhew just threw, I mean, he didn't even set up a double, really. So it might be there, but it would be really difficult. He's throwing the double, though, or throwing the hit and roll. Maybe it's not quite as flat as we thought. We'll see.
Okay. Oh, beautiful. I think.
Yeah, almost.
Well, almost,
yeah.
Yes.
These rocks usually are pretty lively. It just, you know, that turn kind of kept it being a little flatter, kept the angle a little flatter, but it also doesn't come off with as much action. If you'd thrown the other turn and threw the intern in, then it keeps spinning in the same direction, comes off a little quicker. Still a good shot, and still might have a chance or two, because Robert, either if he rolls out here or if he sits somewhere to give Chad another chance at a double, then Chad will certainly go after it, and almost no matter where it is, if there's any chance at a double, he'll play it. Even if it's one of those 1 in 100 shots, I think.
Looks good.
Yeah, I don't know where they want it to end up, but it's going to be pretty good. So Chad will throw the double again here. There's not much doubt about that. He needs to get two. It's not an easy double, but certainly not the hardest double he ever had in his life, I don't think. But you gotta hit it perfect.
Yep, gotta hit it. 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock, looking at it.
So I'm just thinking of that out for a minute. Now, from what position would
I'm
that
looking
be?
At the screen.
At the screen?
Yeah.
Okay. That's perfect, yeah. 2 o'clock. He's hit this at 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock, or from looking where we're looking, but for the audience.
We'll go with that, because, yeah. We could be looking at the wrong sheet for all they know. So Chad's got it on its way. This looks like it might be curling too much already. Or maybe not. They better sweep it.
Yes.
Well, they're not trying to even make it now. Okay.
Okay.
So they gave up right away on the double. I think he got it started, and it just, and Cameron recognized right off the bat that if they kept sweeping it, they might hit it 3/4 and just roll over the top, and he figured, well, we might as well take our one.
That's the first objective.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty tough now. You're down 4 with 3 ends to go, and no hammer, but certainly play this end and see what happens. They'll throw up a couple of guards. And then hopefully for them, the Mayhew team doesn't make the nice peels they made a couple of ends ago.
So a good shot by Middlestat, right on the center line. Mayhew wants this in the house.
Yeah, for sure. He doesn't need any guard, doesn't want and doesn't need any guards.
My gut is saying that it was probably
So you have another guard will go up for a chat here. You need to have a couple. Unfortunately for them, the first one just above the eye in Deloitte there is just a, it's sort of an in-betweener. You'd like it to be a little deeper so that when you set this one up here, you have a little bit more room between them. But it's a good guard. It's just if you know you're going to throw two, you'd like to be able to create some space between the two of them. And certainly they know they're going to throw two. They won't want this one over by very much.
And it's not.
No. You know, Kelly's been a lifelong lead, though, I think, for the most part, and and really gets the game and understands the game and usually has pretty much perfect weight. So no surprise that he was able to drop that just a foot over the hog line. Not an easy task. So they're going to play a tick shot here. My least favorite shot in curling.
The most difficult shot in curling.
Yeah, it can be tough, yeah.
Nope. Okay, it's coming in.
The key to the tick shot first is you have to tick it. And then you figure it out from there. Without the tick, it's just not as effective.
And what your weight.
That's good
weight. Than, yeah.
No, he has to throw that much. He has to make sure if he doesn't hit it, that he doesn't stay anywhere.
Oh, early, yes, he didn't want any lighter.
Yeah, earlier in the game. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, earlier in the game, you'd want to be. Oh, you were. Yeah, sorry,
I
Sharon.
Was thinking it needed a little more.
Needed more. No, yeah, you're right. My apologies on that one. I was thinking.
Okay. Now he's coming in.
Yeah. I don't really think that is a look at that as a bad miss for the Mayhew team, because if you do play the tick shot and make it, the one thing that happens is there's two more rocks in play, and with a four-point lead, even though those rocks might be on the wings somewhere, they're usable to some degree, and I don't know that I really want them used. So I might have just thrown it through anyway myself rather than even try the tick shot.
Yes.
And that's my favorite shot in curling, the throw-a-through shot.
Good practice playing the tick shot, though, because in the 10th end you might need it, and your lead has had a chance to practice it.
Yeah, oh yeah, I agree.
But I agree. My favorite is the throw through as well.
Yeah.
A free perfect shot.
So now you got a little bit of a wonder here. Chad's wondering whether he goes in or throws another guard. I still think that guard there is just a bit of a problem for him. It's just not the right depth, if you will. So Ian Jerlink, second stone for Team Stevens. The guys are down there. Everybody's basically talking about the same thing. Where really should we put this rock? I think they've decided now they're going to go in. Well, right around top of the 8 foot, I suppose, probably would work. Top of the 4 foot might work, but you might not want to be quite that tight. Ian has been a little bit of a struggle for draw weight here the last couple of ends, so we'll see how he gets along here. It's a nice line.
Looks good.
Ian's a world-class piper.
Piper?
Yeah. Mm. Very, very good. Like, world-class, not just, you know, the best in Pictou County kind of thing.
Yes.
You know, because we have some pretty good ones in Pictou County, but, no, he's done tours and all that kind of stuff as a piper. Traveled to a curling camp a few years ago with the Turning Point group, and he brought his bagpipes with him, and we all got to learn how really not to play the bagpipes.
Yes,
we tried
yes.
to learn how to play the bagpipes. Good peel by Neil Gallant.
I don't think you can be a curler and not love the pipes.
No, it's one of those things. To me, it's a little bit like fiddle music. I really like it for a little bit of time. It just, sometimes I don't, especially the fiddle music, I've been here a long time, but I like it a lot, but I just don't like a lot of it.
Yes. Oh, I love it.
Do you?
I hear it and it just does things to me.
Yeah. Pipes are cool, though. I like the pipes. I you know, my favorite piping thing, I don't know the names of all the songs. Obviously, this the traditional song that they play at the Briars and everything is an awesome song. I also, in the song, the Paul McCartney song of Mulligan Tire or whatever, I love that song.
Yes.
And I love the pipes part of that song. So, but back to the curling game.
Yes.
Yeah. So we still, basically it's going to be guard, peel, guard, peel, guard, peel, right to the end here, unless somebody misses. And not a bad setup for Chad, really, at the moment. Even though those rocks are frozen, they're frozen well enough that they're really pretty tough to get rid of both. And you don't want to get too greedy on this shot.
No.
Nope, it's good.
He was thinking, though.
I know. I was wondering. I was thinking, you don't want to do that. If it ever happens to curl up, and even if it hits it right on the nose and jams everything, that might be really bad.
Mm-hmm. These guards are crucial right now.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, if you miss a guard here, then you've basically just about written the game off, to be honest.
Curl too much.
Hey, oh.
A little too much.
Curl a little too much, and then hit a little something, a little flat spot or something there at the end. You know, he still might rip the guard. I don't know. Nope. Yeah, there's a little bit of space there, so these guys can maybe throw it hard enough to get rid of all of those, to be honest. I thought maybe they were dead frozen, it would be really tough, but the freeze used to be such a great shot. It used to be, if you made a good one, it was really good, and nowadays the freeze is just almost a useless shot in curling at this level.
It has to be ultra perfect.
Yep.
So he's going for the double here.
Ultra perfect.
Or nose.
I like that term, ultra perfect.
Ultra perfect.
I'm just learning so much. Reverse freezes and ultra perfect. Just a sec, I got to write that down. Might use that a little later on today. I do have to do two more games today, so ultra perfect.
You're going to need all the help you can get.
I know.
Well, they want to nose this. They want to nose this. Make it curl.
Oh. You know, another half an inch and is absolutely perfect. It would be ultra perfect, but still a pretty good shot. That was a very aggressive call to hit it that way. I actually thought he would have blasted that out. I thought he would have tried to get that one off of there, because I think he, even if he didn't get rid of both of them, I think he certainly could have slid that one out somewhere in the 8-foot area.
Mm-hmm.
So a little bit surprised he didn't try to go at that a little harder.
Yes.
So on sheet three, looking at sheet three for a second, Paul Dexter went at the fifth end break and stole 1-6, stole 2-7, and has a pretty commanding lead over Kendall Thompson, 8-4, playing the eighth. This Dexter team has had sort of a quietly pretty good year, didn't play a lot of events, but when I've seen them, and they're just playing really well, and Marty Gavin's their coach, and they've done a lot of work. They work really hard. One of the teams that you just maybe don't see at every event, but good squad. Definitely a threat to be around at the end of the week here. Brett McDougall held Jamie Murphy to 1 in the 7th end and has a one point lead playing 8 with the hammer. So Chad's got this one coming. It's curling quite a bit. It's just not enough weight on it, I don't think. I'm not even 100% sure what he was playing.
I think he was playing the rock that he's... I think he was playing that.
Was he? Okay.
Jim, yeah.
I thought maybe he was playing a little tap on the yellow or something.
They talked about it, and I may have misunderstood, but they indicated that first, and then they talked about it, but he did have it. It was a little heavy, so... Might have been one of those in-between shots where they decided at the last minute to let it go. I don't know.
So Neil and Robert having a little discussion here. Neil's pretty set on taking that guard off. Robert's thinking, well, you know what? I still really like offense. So if he ever throws a draw in here and makes it and puts it right in that little pocket, he's going to score and the game's basically going to be over. But he could end up with a much harder shot than he would have if he peels his guard.
Yes, he's up that much.
Looking at running it back into the pile, you could do that. I mean, the only trouble is you're going to leave the shooter and you're going to leave probably one or two blue ones in there.
And then Chad can just come around again.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he could be in trouble. If you peel this off, what does Chad do? He probably plays a little tap on the yellow. Real little tap on the yellow, because he really needs to steal. Somewhere he has to steal two. So he has to be thinking two sometime, and this is probably as good a time as any.
Yeah, Yes, if Chad had tapped that yellow one back a bit and rolled into where he is now, would have been much better.
Looks like a timeout. Didn't see anybody signal one, but they obviously call one, and we got 90 seconds to think about it, Sharon, so let's come up with something really good.
Well, whatever works, I guess. I think he should probably take the front off, but...
Yeah, if I'm these guys, if I'm this team, I'm taking the front off.
I mean, you're up four points. You really want to...
And you're going to probably throw your last one looking at two or three, but it's going to be a wide open hit, and worst case scenario, you make a double and give up one. Probably would have a good chance of scoring unless Chad makes an absolute perfect shot. So that's that shot. Not really anything else can go wrong with it. If you play the draw, and... Well, I don't know. If you make it really, really good, I think you win the game on that shot. If you make it anything less than that, though, you're probably going to give up one and maybe two, depending on what it does. So I think they're going to peel by the time it's all done.
You're going out to it, so...
Just a matter... Yeah.
Yeah. Hit it on the broom
side.
Burdock's
still looking at...
Yeah, clear it up.
Getting in there, yeah. Sometimes you really have to think about what's the right shot versus what your heart tells you sometimes when you think you have a chance to finish a game or whatever. You can't. This sport has never been a good sport to try to finish teams off early sometimes. If you get a little excited, you just things get messy.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes you have to think about, what does the opposition want me to do?
A really, really good point, and particularly a good point for anybody that's trying to be a competitive player, and whether you're a junior or an adult or whatever, and if you're confused out there, that's an excellent thought, Sharon. If you just think about, well, if I was the other team, what would I want me to play?
A bit full. Ooh.
I don't even understand that shot. I don't even understand the approach to that shot. They didn't look like they were sweeping it hard to make sure that it got it off of there.
Yes, they should have been on that.
Yeah, I think
like
that's
crazy.
Yeah, I think you're pounding that all the way.
Yes, with the ability of those sweepers, they could have held it, I would think.
Well, they could have held it a little bit better than that, maybe at least lost one of those blue ones and moved the yellow one over a little bit further. You know, you gain 4, 5, 6 inches sometimes is the difference between being able to make a shot and not. Chad puts that right where they're signaling right now. Robert has no shot to score and maybe no shot for anything better than giving up two.
Yes. Oh, that was very unfortunate.
Yeah, pretty casual approach to that shot, I think. It just... It's like one of those timeouts when you're a coach, and when done a lot of coaching as a junior, you call a timeout, and then that sort of thing happens. You're like, well, that was a complete useless waste of time.
Yes.
I got two of them in a whole game.
Yes.
And we just used one to do nothing, or actually to go backwards even.
Right.
But anyway, that happens. Maybe just a little casual.
Yes, that had to be... And that rock had to be swept badly.
This is
looks like a good guard.
It's going to be a good guard. Not as good as it could have been, I don't think, but still a pretty good guard. Bringing in another 4 feet, I think it's gooder. But you're going to have him draw on the 4 foot, looking at three in a game that he leads 7-3. Just not really any need for that having to happen, I don't think.
No.
And hard to get, well, I guess, you can come by tight enough, you can probably get shot rock, but I don't know if you're going to play it that tight. I'm thinking you're going to want to make sure you get by the guard. And
yes.
Chances are pretty good you're going to give up a couple here. So we'll see. Robert, like we said a number of times, other than that last shot, Robert's had just a great day, made pretty much everything, so I won't be shocked to see him make this one.
Wait, looks... I got a 3-7-1 back line to Hogg.
Well, judging by what we had earlier, that should be close.
You better get on it.
He's okay for line. Got all kinds of rooms. Just
he's
a matter
of weight.
Weight,
yes.
I think he's going to be...
Too much line.
He threw it good, but...
Good weight.
Yeah, kind of what we thought. Steal of two. So that's...
Yes.
That was a very nice draw, but like I said, it's just one of them draws that you just don't want to get close to the guard, so it makes it difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So it's steal to two for Team Stevens, Chad Stevens, and now trails 7-5, again without Hammer playing the nine, so it's super good situation for Team Mayhew. But Chad's probably feeling like, hey, I got a chance now, and just probably 15 minutes ago really was playing the eighth end just to get the rocks down to this end, and then figured we'd go for lunch. But anyway, you never know. You really never know.
Never know in the game of curling.
No, you're right. Yeah, that peel shot was just kind of a little bizarre. I just don't really know. I don't know what happened there. I don't know if missed something or I don't know what happened there either. Kelly was just about to throw and then stopped. So we're in the ninth. What has become now a reasonably tight game with a 7-5 score here at the Deloitte Tankard at the Mayflower Curling Club, where everybody that wants to watch great curling should be today and for the rest of the week. This event goes on right until Sunday. The finals are on Sunday. The round robin goes on for the next couple of days. Men's and women's, both eight teams on both sides play a seven-game round robin, so seven games each just to get to the point of the playoffs. Top three teams make the playoffs. First place team has a bye to the final, and second and third playoff for that other spot in the final. So lots of curling. You can go to nscurl.com or .com or ca. .com to check out the schedule. You can find out who's playing who, when they're playing, and all that kind of stuff, what the standings are. And if you're at home and you just want to know how the other games are going, because you just don't see those on our broadcast, you can go there as well and follow the scoreboard. The scoreboard's there, and it's updated every end or every two ends for sure. And you can be as up to date as we are up here, sometimes even more. So what are we doing here, Sharon? Going right in or another guard?
I think he's going right in.
Okay. Yeah, it's a bit.
Oh,
of a
maybe not.
It's hard to tell.
He's trying to go in, I guess. Sweep it. No, still short. That's good.
Yeah, that's better, I think.
Yeah.
It would be nice to line them up a little bit. So
I'll
play another tick shot.
Another tick shot. He's practicing.
Yeah.
For the last end. Sometimes the ninth end is as critical as the tenth.
Oh, so you're right. Yeah. He's closer this time.
Yep, he's playing it away.
I'd keep sweeping it.
Very good.
Yeah, perfect.
Excellent shot.
Perfect. Had a couple chances at it. And
if he hadn't practiced in all those other ends, he might not have made that
shot. Well, exactly, yep. Should have been playing that the whole game. So we have Ian Gerling now being asked to throw a guard. He really needs Stevens going to need at least one guard out there. We found out the last end one might be enough, but I think you'll want to try to have a couple.
Good spot.
Yeah, it's a good shot. There's going to be always going to be a chance of a double peel no matter what. If you line them up dead straight, it makes it really hard to make a double peel, but that's also really hard to line them up dead straight. So Neil Glant now. This one's got to curl a little bit more. You don't want to nose this. Ouch.
Too bad they didn't sweep that. They looked like it wanted to hang.
Yeah. I don't know if they're afraid of the one in the house or if just there's just a little bit of nerves entering into it here now, trying to maybe make a little too much out of some shots, and they'll get it back. Great.
So they want this behind and on the forefoot.
Yeah, for sure. Got a great opportunity here. You got two guards and chance to get in. Ian's got a much better shot there. And just didn't quite go as deep as he liked, but that's a good spot.
Yeah.
Get that one to the top of the forefoot. It's a dandy shot. Well, this one's going to definitely not hit it on the nose. Neil made sure on that one. Very well.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Almost got the other.
That one he might have been a little okay to hit it on the nose, but the he just kind of helped that one a little bit at the start. Just got the intern going a little bit and making sure he didn't do anything silly with it. And got rid of the one that mattered. McCray playing the peel.
Mm-hmm.
I think you probably would have liked to have maybe got that one going a little bit straighter back too, but you gotta make sure of the peel first and make sure you don't leave that shooter around anywhere bad. And they took care of that, so not a bad situation for either team yet. It's good for Stevens because he has some rocks to work with and he has to steal. Can't afford to really even give up one. One means you play the eighth in, and you do. They do sometimes see these teams get three in the eighth to tie a game up, but it's kind of rare. Cameron throwing another guard. At the same time, Robert does have that one in the 8 foot, which is not a bad position. This might be not good. This could possibly set up the triple.
Triple.
Looks to me like it could be.
Outturn.
Throw this one hard. It might drag it past it. It might miss the back one. But it's really close.
His intern, he's a lefty. This should see how this works.
Need to hit it just about on the nose.
Ooh, a little full.
You know, I actually would call that a complete miss in my books. It's, at this level, in my curling game, that might not be a complete miss, but at this level, you need to make those shots. Like, that was a relatively easy double for sure, and maybe double and tick the other one or triple or whatever, but you just need to make that one, and that's I hate to say that, but that's a big miss. It's,
yes.
You know, because now Chad's looking at, hitting and rolling or whatever. I guess he's going to play that hit and roll behind those guards. And now it gets a little messy for the team, for Team Mayhew here. You had that one opportunity. You got to take advantage of those single opportunities sometimes to change around and in. Stuart Thompson cracked a three in the eighth end over there in his game against Mike Fleming. So he's taken control of that game after a really tight battle. He's up three playing in the ninth. And Brent McDougall made his last shot over here in sheet five to score one in the eighth, take a two-point lead over Jamie Murphy going to the ninth. So a couple of games there still. This one and the Murphy-McDougall game certainly still winnable by either team. The other two games are getting a little out of hand, or a little out of reach, I should say, not necessarily out of hand. So this one's got to curl a little bit, I think.
Yes.
Gonna curl quite a bit, I think.
Whoa.
Gonna roll out.
Trying to make it curl.
They don't do that much of that, this team. I'm surprised. We really haven't seen them do a lot of real hard sweeping to try to make it curl, where most of the teams were still seeing people doing that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a bit rare. So
it seems to work on a rock that's not too heavy. That was quite heavy, so maybe
yeah,
it would have worked. But
yeah, you're right. I think he did overthrow that. He didn't have to throw it that hard, mm-hmm, for sure. So. So we're playing the double peel, I assume, Sharon, you think?
Yes, for sure.
Okay. Well, if he makes this one, Chad really hasn't got very much. He'll go around one of those corners and let Robert draw the 8 foot first point. Pretty tight.
He's not going to make the double.
Never really was even close on that.
No. So, Chad can still get behind that one.
Yeah, and that one's on the ring, so if he goes around this, Robert's probably playing the double or the run back or something. He's not going to draw against two, I don't think, in a 7-5 game, and wouldn't be surprised at all to see Chad steal one here without really having to make any great shots through this end. Mayhew's team, both back-to-back shots, two great opportunities to completely get out of this end and haven't been able to make those.
This has to be perfect.
Just one thing I've never liked about these iPhones is you drop them and they just don't bounce. You have to actually bend over and pick them up. Anyway, hopefully they still work, which so far we're okay.
We're okay. Hit the carpet.
Yeah.
So I got a 3-6-2 on this.
3-6-2.
Which is heavy, you know, not keen, keen, keen.
You're very accurate with that watch.
I use it a lot.
We use steam bolts. Do you remember when you were a kid and you used to count one steam bolt, two steam bolts? Well, that's what our team uses.
That's a good idea. I'll try that.
I wouldn't. It's not that accurate.
My skip likes for me to throw this thing away.
Does it? Yeah. You're playing ladies, you mean?
Yes.
Ladies skip, yeah. I think they're a great tool. I think they're awesome. I think they're really good. I think people can get really zoned into them too much, and that's the big problem. And,
yes.
You know, I played with mostly the same guys for, I don't know, some 30 years almost now, maybe more, actually. And, you know, when they discovered the whole split time, my lead when he discovered the whole split time thing back a few years ago was okay with it at first, and then it got to the point where it was like the ultimate being or something, this stopwatch, just whatever it said he went with. And now he's gotten pretty good. Now he's kind of at the point where it is a guide like it should be and not an automatic. So as we kind of called that one, basically, and Robert certainly with a chance to make the double there, but doesn't quite make it. Needed to curl another inch or so. Gives up a steal and one to Stevens, and what was a handshake-type game a couple of hands ago is now a nail-biter playing the 10th end with Robert Mayhew leading Chad Stevens 7-6 with hammer. Of course, we've been saying with hammer for about an hour now. With hammer playing the 10th end. So still a good situation for Mayhew, no question about that, but they got to regroup a little bit. They need to play a good 10th end here because they haven't played a great couple of ends.
So this is a critical shot for Kelly's making sure that the ice is clean in front of him.
So we have one final over here. Team Dexter did defeat Kendall Thompson. I don't know what happened in the ninth end. I think they got another couple of points or so. So it probably about a 10-4 final. It was 8-4 going into that ninth end. And I think I heard the other guy, heard Joel or John say 2. So I think it must have ended up 10-4. They shook hands. So Kelly, same thing here. He wants this guard to be really close to the rings without going in. It's a hard thing as a sweeper to make that happen. That's just about perfect. Would have liked to have been on the center line, but that's pretty good. So now we'll see the tick shot. Yeah.
This is the one he's been practicing all game.
It is, and this is the most important one he's thrown so far. The other ones were kind of shots that, like I said, you could just throw them away, and that would have been not so bad. This one here has a bearing on the outcome of the game, or potentially has a bearing on the outcome of the game. Has to curl quite a bit more yet.
Here it comes.
You know what? He's going to be really close.
Yeah, they're trying to make
be really
that curl.
Close. I think he's got a great shot. Chad's never getting that out. He can sweep, but not that hard.
Nope.
So, changed up the front. Did leave a rock that they can use, that Stevens teams could use, but at least it's there, so they always have it available as a run back. Move the blue one off the line. So a very nice shot by the lead, Neil Burdock. Is that right? Am I saying that right? I think so. Yeah. Nick Burdock, not Neil Burdock.
Sorry,
yeah.
I moved that.
Nick. I don't know this team so well, actually. I haven't seen them as much, and I don't travel around the circle or anything anymore. My days of playing that are over, and I don't see a lot of these teams on a regular basis, but some of them I've known for a long time, so it's not too bad. But Roberts seems a little bit new to me.
And what club are they out of, Jim?
Be here in the city. I'm not sure which club.
Okay.
I don't know if it tells us in the guide, does it? Might say in there. We'll just ask the fans. Where do they play out of? Lakeshore?
Lakeshore.
Okay. Well, we did some research. New research systems, there's new systems we have in place are great for finding out details. We found out from Robert's mom that they play at a Lakeshore. So, as Sharon just said, Lakeshore is a great club, great ice, good place to play. No question. They have Brian Rayfields makes the ice over there, and it's really nice. Busy spot, mm-hmm. Big club room, but a really nice facility. They do a great job over there. Karen Skivington, who's officiating here this week, is actually the manager over there. She does a great job, and they do a wonderful job with junior curling. They really support junior curling over there, and they've hosted a lot of events. They hosted the junior for 3 years, and this year I think they're hosting the new junior doubles event, which has 100 teams, 30 teams or something entered into it. It's great, all the way from 11 years old and up, so that's going to be a fun weekend. So another guard going up here for Ian Jurlink. Need to get this one right about on that O. It's been my goal for the whole game.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
Look at that. Took 10 ends, but we made it happen. Does the angle's right to make a double peel here, though. I will say these guys are, not making double peels is not that rare for them. And certainly an opportunity here for Neil Gallant to change this end around. I think he's close. Guess to curl a little more, maybe. Might get the one in the house. It's amazing how often you see that happen.
Mm-hmm.
I think they almost plan it, but I don't think they really do.
I think he'd like to have gotten rid of that front one.
Yeah, I agree. But that's a nice bonus.
But that's good, yeah.
Yep. If nothing else, it probably means you end up throwing your last shot maybe only against one instead of against two, which is, mm-hmm. Which is helpful. I guess it's not supposed to matter at this level, but I bet it does sometimes. This, again, I think is supposed to be a guard, but this is going to be not good unless it lines up dead straight.
Okay, well.
Well.
Super shot, heavy, could get rid of both, but.
Yeah. He has just had a little bit of a rough day with the draw weight. He hasn't been horrible. He just seems to be just that little bit off. Just mm-hmm. can't seem to kind of nail it. He's off by 4 or 5 feet on most draws, where they're a little heavy, a little light. Good player, really good player, but just struggling a little bit with the precision today. So Neil Gallant with a chance to really take this end to a totally different dimension. And he will.
Beauty.
So a great shot. The boys finally took advantage of their opportunities. That's, you know, the third time we've sort of said, well, they've had a great chance to change it in the round, and this is the first time they did. So it's a great shot by Neil Gallant. And Mayhew should end up with not too difficult a shot on his last one if they just make the basics here. Chad has no choice but to throw up the guard. He'll do that probably three times.
Mm-hmm. That last one could be the shot that wins the game.
Yeah, that's pretty fair to say, I think.
Chad will hope for a nose hit, but...
And I think Brent McDougall over there had a chance to draw and sit two and force Jamie Murphy to take his one, and he went a little too far, I think, and Jamie might be hitting for two or three possibly over there. We'll let you know in a minute, but for now, Chris McCray will try to peel that blue one out. Ooh, a little tight. Might be able to back it up. Yeah, he's okay. The skip stands up and gives a little hand signal, then you know, yeah, all right, he's all right. Good shot. Murphy picked up his deuce over there on five, and we're tied up coming home in that one. Brent McDougall having last rock. Chad trying to move the guards around a little bit. You know, it's, you say, why doesn't he put it right back on the center line? Well, just grasping a little bit, trying to find a spot where maybe the peel's a little tougher, maybe they haven't thrown one, maybe the person hits it not quite on the nose and actually rolls 2-3 feet to the left, but they're still close to the center line. Just really a matter of trying to just stick it out there somewhere and cross your fingers and see what happens. It was a little tiny bit out, maybe. I think he's okay, though.
That's a piece.
Yeah, great shot. Great shot. Nice thing about that weight. We talked about it yesterday, and it's got to be a bonus when you can throw the hard one like that. It's just it's like hitting a 240-yard drive. It's got to be nicer than being able to hit it only 200 yards. So, not that I would know. But it just makes the game that much easier. And most of the men's teams now have it, and most of the women's teams are not that much further behind. They're like Colton Steele threw a peel yesterday, they clocked 6.0 seconds, and I thought, wow, I don't know that you could actually physically throw it any harder than that. Those guys do that regularly. Speaking of which, the Stuart Thompson game is all over there, so they obviously scored again in the ninth, and they must have shaken hands. We didn't even see them disappear. We were so entrenched in our game. So Thompson improves to 2-0, and Fleming drops to 0-2. Dexter, same thing, improves to 2-0. And Kendall Thompson drops to 0-2. And we'll tell you what happens here in a minute. We won't quite make it to the end of the McDougall-Murphy game over there. It doesn't look like, unless something really dramatic happens here. So you'll have to maybe catch that one online. You can check it out on nscurl.com. Find the scoreboard and see what the outcome of that one is.
So Chad's trying every angle he can here to get a nose hit or get a hit and roll to the center line so he can hide.
That one's pretty extreme out there. I wouldn't have thought he'd actually quite go that far out. But still, like I said a minute ago, really it's just finger crossing time. And so Robert's got it on the way, and I think he's fine.
Yeah, pretty straight.
Good shot. So a nice end by the Mayhew team here with just two rocks to come. It's a really nice, clean 10th end. They've had two or three ends in a row that just got a little away from them. So Good for them. Should have just a wide open hit for the win in 35 or 40 seconds or so. So again, just like to remind everybody, we do have games coming up today at 12, 4, and 8. Men are on at 4, the women are on at 12 and 8. Two games, every draw here on Bell Alliance TV 1. At the Nova Scotia Men's and Women's Curling Championships, sponsored by Kruger and the Scotties people. And Deloitte on the men's side. Chad just figuring out, well, is there some place we can throw this where Robert hasn't seen a rock thrown yet? Mm-hmm. Or maybe can do something wrong with it? Still talking about it. They got a couple of minutes. They're fine. Maybe they get a little TV sponsorship stuff where the longer they're on, the more money they get.
He's throwing the out turn over to the corner.
Yeah, he'll try to hang it out there and hope there's something funny out there when Robert throws his. Or, you know, and sometimes in curling club ice, that's the case. You know, you get out there far enough and there's falls or things like that. I don't think it'll be a problem here. I think Robert will just put it. They got to get it there, first of all. No, he's okay.
Yep. Good weight.
Threw it out there in the 12 and a half foot circle. But Robert will be able to put it right on the rock, really, and throw it overhand and have no problems hitting it, I don't think. But you have to throw it because we have seen stranger things happen. So Robert Mayhew with his last rock coming here in the 10th end with a chance to win the game, even his record at 1-1. Bring Chad Stevens back down to the pack a little bit at 1-1 as well. Big shot. Mayhew team's had a very good game. Had a couple of rough ends there, or just a couple of rough shots maybe even, but overall played a good game and very worthy of the victory here should they end up getting it.
So even if he rolls out here, he's okay.
Yeah, that's yeah. Enough, so. That's a bonus with a 1-point lead. Not much panic here, so I think he's fine.
Looks good.
Yeah, good throw.
He even stays.
And even scores one. So at the Deloitte Tanker, in our game we just did, Mayhew scores one in the 10th and defeats Chad Stevens by a score of 8-6. Good effort by the Mayhew team today. They did play very well, as I've said. Chad's team certainly wasn't at their best, but at the same time, you know, it's you got to take advantage of those situations. And it did get a little nervy at the end, and the team held in there, and good to see. So the final score again, 8-6, Mayhew defeating Stevens. And we'll be back with you at 12 o'clock for the Scotties draw, the women's draw at noon. Thank you very much.